watching Mystery School, the first late night show on the net, with your hosts Owen Bones and Tony B. Jr. Let's begin.
Yes, yes, it is us.
Yes.
We DJ housewarmings, we DJ house parties, we DJ divorce hearings. Anything you need, come and talk to us. We charge by the hour.
Yes.
That's it, man. And that'll be enough.
That'll be enough, everybody.
That'll be enough.
All right, everyone. Welcome back. It's the Mystery School stream on a Wednesday. Thank you for being here with us. If you're looking forward to an action-packed Wednesday stream, can we please have another round of question marks and or Mystery School Union emotes in the chat? Please.
We need them.
Now, it's time. I did a big update on the Mystery School playlist, by the way. Well, it's not huge, but I'm saving up some tracks to do a huge update. But there is a new update on the Mystery School playlist if you're looking for some new shit to listen to. Question mark playlist, or click the link below the stream. I will plug that again later.
Let's go.
That's
let's
all.
Let's go.
Later.
There we go. All right. All of our friends are here. Our family's here. Bird Circus in here. Teriyaki. Lady Sen. Just Lynn. First Nation Sensation. Dipped in Twitch. Ray J. Unique. Knack Lord. Aggie Panda, Adriana, Dr. Reem, welcome back, everyone.
Good you to guys see you. Looking great, looking beautiful tonight. Let's see what happened with that tweet. The shorter shorted it once again. Let's see here. There will be penalties for this. I told you. Don't short the. Okay. Yep.
Yes.
226,000 channel points went to the shorters.
Oh man, the shorters won again.
Shit. All right, we're gonna figure this out. Don't worry about
well,
it.
Well, while they may have shorted the Mystery School Go Live tweet successfully, we do have some good news, everyone. Chuck English of the Cool Kids fame has officially followed the Mystery School stream live on air.
Nice. After having been a live Twitch stream and Twitter page for the past maybe 3 years,
yes.
And of which he is very close friends, if not family members, with the two members that run said
and
page.
Also having been a guest on the show multiple times over the course of 3 years.
Also having had been a guest on the show multiple times. We finally got that Chuck English follow on Twitter, y'all. Let's give another round of applause for that, man, because
yes.
I think that is something to really brag about, man.
He also has his own emote. Thank you, chat, for reminding us of that.
The only person to have his own emote in our stream that just now followed the stream.
Thank you, Chuck English, if you're out there, for blessing us with the follow on the Mystery School account. We appreciate that.
Dude ass got a whole emote on this stream and just followed us on Twitter.
Hell yeah. All right. Also, chat, you know the deal. It's the Wednesday Mystery School stream. We're about to start the news. Every single item of news we talk about on the stream is sourced by you, dear viewer, in the stream news section of the Discord. Question mark Discord in the chat if you're not already in there, or click the link below. But if you're new here and you don't know, if we hit this sub goal on Wednesdays and Fridays, we will make a full song live in under 30 minutes, and you get to pick the topic based off of all the news articles that we've talked about on stream. And since we were so enamored with this shit on Monday's stream, we're bringing back the AI guest feature if we hit it tonight. This shit was just too crazy. Young Shepin, thank you for that gifted sub, man. We
my shit
that.
Right there. I love this thing, man. It's, maybe we should we give him a preview of the possibilities that this AI has?
I don't remember who I rendered here. Let's check this one.
I'm a splash puppet. I want it into the head of the...
Oh, that's Grover.
Oh,
that's
Grover from Sesame Street, everybody. Let's get a listen.
I'm a splash, Papa Pill. I want even to the half do the whole thing. I'm a last pussy so good I never fuck you in the East. Got
that's Shaggy from Scooby-Doo right there. Tight.
Fuck you in the East is what he said. I'll never fuck you in the East.
What else did we get?
I'm a splash, Papa's IP. I want to even do the half do the...
It's Carl Weezer,
God,
y'all.
Carl Weezer kind of stroked out at
really,
the end there.
Really, really wheezing there.
And I think we have one more. Who is this?
I'm a splash. A pill, one e, the doodle, half to the...
Oh, that's Sonic. That's Sonic the Hedgehog.
Ah.
Yes.
Good
Anthony.
Old racially charged Sonic right there, man.
Anthony, thank you for subbing for 2 months in advance, man. We appreciate
Let's
that.
Let's go, Anthony. Appreciate
helping
that.
Helping our commitment issue one step at a time.
Well, right. that's the AI that we will include on a sudden death verse tonight if we crack that sub goal in the corner, y'all. The possibilities are just endless.
Last time we had so many great options to choose from. Jimmy Neutron was in there. SpongeBob was in there. Shadow the Hedgehog was a potential contender. Anthony.
Oh, God, with a five piece right there. Thank you, Anthony.
Thank
Let's go.
For the five gifted. Appreciate
it. Turn it up. All right. We're getting closer and closer to that sub goal. We might have this AI on a verse tonight. It's all up to y'all.
Thank you very much. We appreciate that. The subbing in advance and the 5 gifted. Thank you, everyone who's gifted so far. We're already like a third of the way to tonight's Sudden Death Unlock. It is looking good. And regardless of if Sudden Death happens or not, we got some... just some bangers to talk about tonight in terms of the
news.
Some
stuff, man.
We got some stuff. But we have to start it off, as always, with some letters from the class.
Yes, as we should, man. We got some great ones.
I got one pulled up.
Oh, yeah. Go ahead first. I'll follow up.
So this is from Anonymous. Thank you for writing in. Also, if you want to write in on the stream and have your question, comment, or concern discussed live on air, check the letters from the class section of the Discord. We pull them out right before we go live. Lame James with the 10 gifted subs.
Let's go, Lame James. Appreciate you, bro. I hope you're doing well.
Welcome
man. I
back,
hope the
man.
Power is back on. It probably is because you're watching the stream from somewhere, so I'm assuming your power is back on.
Yes.
But Godspeed, my boy. Thank
James,
you.
James, welcome back, man. Thank you so much for the 10 gifted. We appreciate you, dog. All right. This question is from Anonymous. This girl I'm talking to on Bumble right now likes the Lumineers and shit, which is fine, but I just don't know if I put on some Rob or nudie, she not gonna vibe, and I can't figure out if that's a deal breaker or not. So I'm assuming your question is whether or not you should go forward with meeting up with this girl who likes the Lumineers and shit, even though your music taste skews towards Young Nudie and Rob Banks. So, dude, let me suggest a possible outcome here to you. I think you should meet up with her. I think you should be open about this and play that shit. And then depending on how she reacts, that would be the deal breaker. If she gets scared and starts clutching her purse and shit, then, you know, it probably wasn't going to work out. But maybe she's open-minded. Everyone has their guilty pleasure music. I can't say I enjoy the Lumineers, but, you know, what would you do in our anonymous circumstance here?
So just to recap, this anonymous person is trying to meet up with a new girl, with a different taste in music, it seems
yes.
like, which is tough. That happens. So I would suggest for you to, you blast it at full volume until you either scare her away or maybe she comes around. You know, I think
yeah.
that's probably mm-hmm. the only option, because if you don't, if you just like kind of sweep it under the rug, then you'll have to eventually like talk mm-hmm. about it, because you probably want to listen to your
right.
music at some point in time in life. So you can't hide from it.
We can't acknowledge that there is a threshold of like attractiveness where you would be like, hell yeah, girl, I love Arcade Fire and The National.
Yeah.
You know, and so sometimes that's just how it goes. So you just gotta kind of see how it's going.
You might be good. Most girls love Rob Banks, man. You might be good.
Yeah.
They're scared of his music mostly, but they like Rob Banks. So you just gotta
right.
like show him a video or something. They're like, oh, okay, cool. Mm-hmm. Well, I fuck with it.
Hell yeah.
He looks all cool. He's got like a
right.
lot of face tattoos and stuff. She'll love it. Just play the song.
We got 4Color Zach in the chat. Welcome back, dude. Good to see you. Ghost.
What's up, 4Color Zach?
Right now.
All right,
you got
dive
a question
into
here.
One. Yeah, I got a pretty. This is one from my 4D Megamind big brains out there,
okay.
man. All my smarties stand up. This one is from an anonymous author as well. It says, I work at a college as a janitor. Even though I feel like I'm smarter than most people who go there, sometimes I see an equation written on a blackboard, like half an equation, and I just figure it out.
Wait, is this a
plot to that fucking movie? What is that, Goodwill Hunting?
Wait a second.
I know that plot from somewhere, man. I don't think that's not a movie, right?
Well,
I think we've been bamboozled. That was fake.
Anonymous, you should put your skills to good use is all we can say there. Yeah, that was
and
definitely Goodwill Hunting.
Yeah, and who's that bastard in that movie? It was was it Matt Damon?
I don't even remember.
It's one of those assholes, man. It's either Ben or Matt Damon
mixed,
or it's Matt Damon.
I mixed
yeah,
that
so
movie up with like fucking Rain Man.
It's all the same.
Anyway, yeah. Well, thank you, Anonymous, for writing in.
Oh yeah. Well, you a jerk, Anonymous. Yeah. If you got another one, you can go ahead and take the next one.
Let's do one or two more here. Anonymous says, "Dear Mystery School, today I went to Uber Eats. The ice cream lord."
The Lord of Ice Cream? What a...
With the 20.
It's a 20 piece, y'all.
Oh, God.
Everybody hit the deck. We got a 20.
Oh, dude, I found a bank statement under here.
Oh, I thought you was about to say you found a Banksy painting under there. I was about to like, damn, bro.
Oh, Slaughterbox with another 10. Get back down.
The alarm is still going. It's fucking popping. It's only Wednesday, y'all. Guard your grill.
Oh, dude, I found a birthday card down here.
Damn, you should go down there more often. You can find two things at once.
Yeah, there's a lot of shit on the floor of the studio here. Wow. Okay. Anyway, Slopterbox, thank you for the 10 gifted subs, the 20 Let's tonight, go. And Ice Cream Lord with the 20
ice cream.
In fucking one go right there. We salute
Big salute
you,
right there. We love y'all, man.
Thank you. Thank you both. We really appreciate that, guys. Holy shit, the stream is lit today, and we're not even beyond the letters from the class yet.
We are still Jesus. In the letters from the class. I'm loving it. Teriyaki, thank you for throwing it in as well, man.
Thank you, dude. We appreciate you, man. Dude, we gotta finish this question here. This is a okay. good one. Anonymous says, Dear Mystery School, today I went to Uber Eats and saw a McDonald's had nuggets for free $3.99. So I called up my girls and sent them all nuggets.
Sick.
That's tight as fuck. Nugget main emotes in the chat, please. I thought that would resolve in a question, but just cool.
Lit. Speaking of Nugget main, I guess for the last, I guess this is a comment more so than a question. It says, arrest Nugget main.
Oh,
send Nugget main to the gulag and don't let him leave. I don't know why. This was actually written yesterday before Nugget Mane's epic freestyle tonight, so I don't know.
You might have won over the hearts and minds with the Nugget Mane freestyle.
Nugget Mane might have won over a couple new fans with his freestyle tonight, but we'll take that in consideration. We might arrest him because he does have several warrants in the state of Illinois that we need to talk about.
He does, mostly for driving without a license, which is strange. Dr. Ream posts two Nugget Mane emotes and says, damn, he tripping. Yeah, our viewers love Nugget Mane, except for a couple of them. But, you know, everyone who does love Nugget Mane, they really love Nugget Mane.
Oh, wait, we got a special announcement here. So boom, in the chat says, I'm drunk.
Five more. Dude, wait.
Slopter box, let's go.
So boom, in the chat, let's just reiterate that, says, I'm drunk, exclamation mark.
Yes, just to make sure everybody is aware that So Boom is drunk, y'all. Go ahead and give a round of applause for their success.
If you are also drunk in the chat, can we please get a nasty rum style? Jesus, Slopterbox with another
young
five.
Jay.
Young Jay with 10 gifted subs.
Young Jay.
Wow, guys.
Wow.
Thank you so much. Holy shit.
It's going nuts, man. And we get a lot more drunk people coming through the chat announcing that they're also wasted off alcohol in the middle of the stream. So congrats, guys.
Posting a nasty rum style. Thank you for the nasty rum styles in the chat, everyone.
Y'all
Holy shit.
Nasty.
Dude, Young Jay, thank you so much for the 10 gifted. Slopterbox with 25. Unique with 5. What's
Unique
going on?
Unique with another 5 ball. Let's go. We still in the letters from the class right now.
Wow. Thank you so much, everyone. Dude, Unique, the GOAT, here since day one. We appreciate you, dude. Welcome
Big
back.
Big salute. Thank we appreciate. We appreciate.
All right.
Oh, one more congratulations for Ice Cream Lord as well for having his last probation meeting, a free man
W.
a week from today. Ice Cream Lord is back, and he is on the streets, a free man once again.
Let's get some W's in the chat for Ice Cream Lord, please. This man has been rocking with
big
us
dub.
Hard as fuck. Congratulations, dude.
Big W. Seriously. Big W. Good shit, man. I know that shit is not easy. Congrats, bro.
Dude, Bryce with 5 gifted subs.
It's B-Rice. I think it's the AI, man. I think everybody want to see that AI verse. They got the possibility of Grover rapping. They got a possibility of Shaggy from Scooby-Doo. Ben Shapiro. Fucking Michael Myers. Yes. Does Michael Myers even talk, though?
He'll just be like... Joe, Bryce, thank you so much for the 5. Frost the King with the gifted sub as well. Thank you for the generosity tonight, everyone. It's feeling good on a Wednesday. Thank you for being here with us.
Wow.
I think we have to start the stream now, man. There's way too much to get through. And
let's give it a shot. Terry, thank you for the last one to push us up to the 100 mark right there. That
Holy
is 100
shit.
Gifted subs at the beginning of the stream, y'all.
Wow.
I am beyond in love with all of you, and
Holy
I'll have,
shit.
Man, I'll have some sex with you.
100 gifted subs has been hit. We're going to do Sudden Death tonight. Full song, start to finish, in under 30 minutes. You pick the topic that's coming up in exactly 1 hour and 23 minutes. Stick around for that. That means we got to do a lot of news in the meantime, man. What do you say we just get it started here?
Yeah, let's get it cracking, man.
All right.
It's time for the Mystery School stream.
Cursed drip news up first. Well, actually, you get to decide if it's cursed. Bape unveils new collab collection with M&M's. What's
not the worst thing ever.
It could be a lot worse, but it does beg the question, why?
Yeah.
Why?
Sucks, but not the worst thing ever. I've seen way worse things. I can't even be too mad. Nothing I would buy or like to have, but Not the worst thing.
Yeah, it's, I guess it's inoffensive, I guess. I mean, rocking, you know, Hypebeast are already going to be rocking these with those Adidas Eminem collab sneakers that we covered on the stream on Monday.
And if they're a high schooler that hardly attends high school a lot and skips school a lot, they'll have on the accompanying Eminem racing jacket to go with this whole fit to complete the trifecta.
Any teachers in the chat, be on the lookout for students that are wearing the full Eminem fit. They may need extra love and attention. To prevent them from, you know, falling onto a bad track in society. So be on the lookout. Yeah, I guess it's not the worst. It's okay. That one is
that's kind of the worst right there.
That one
right
is
there.
Actually really bad.
That's really edging on the worst potential right there.
God.
Yeah, okay. It's going there. It's edging towards worse. Oh, that one, I don't know why the red one doesn't look that bad. The red one is okay.
These are...
still hurts, though.
So on the spectrum of Margiela cum shoe to Cookie Monster fitted hat, this is skewing dangerously towards Cookie Monster fitted hat.
Yes. Only thing saving it from Cookie Monster fitted fandom is the Bathing Ape. Cookie Monster fitted fans, they don't really get into name brands like Bathing Ape and shit like that, so that's the only thing keeping it out of that region.
This guy's having a bit of a hard time keeping a straight face.
He knows that he's wearing some clown-ass shit right now, and he can't hold in his laugh,
that,
man.
That CAS, the clown-ass shit, has just been known. Terry, dude, thank you for that gifted sub, man. Welcome back. We love you.
Yes, yes, y'all.
Ice Cream Lord says, this stinks, man, with just one of those sideways, like...
Yeah. It's just a little disheartening, that's all,
it's,
man.
It's a little disheartening. If you are an upstart fashion brand, starting your day ready to seize the world and grow your marketing reach, and you log on and see Eminem's Bathing Ape collab, I think my will to live would be chiseled down just a little bit more.
Just a little bit. It's not give it all up yet, right. Just yet, but a couple more collabs like this, and you might want to keep that person under supervision.
A couple more collabs like this, and you'll definitely go back to... accounting school to get an undergrad degree or something. So anyway, could be worse. Let's just keep moving through this the drip segment of today's stream. This next one, man,
worst.
I don't understand. Ruffles the Chip Armored Ridge Tops shoes. Ruffles the Chip brand put a gigantic fucking chip-esque a panty liner on the front of some Nikes here, and
I'm getting real Sir Lancelot vibes from these. I'm getting real the Black Knight or Arthur and his court of savages or whatever the fuck they were.
Yo, Kia, welcome back. Kia's in the chat says, we biting down on those.
What's up, Kia? Yes. We biting down on these. They look like they probably would have a nice crunch to them, man. Definitely. So let's bite these shoes, y'all.
Oh, yeah. There is a countdown timer as well. I didn't notice that. The next drawing is coming up in 2 days, 1 hour, 18 minutes, and 43 seconds, if anyone is so inclined.
Oh, Kilo Grammar says, ridged for her pleasure. Yes, they are indeed fuckable, these shoes are.
They're ridged for someone's pleasure, but not mine. Because I don't really like them. They do make me want ruffles, though, honestly. I think if that's the goal of the collaboration, then they do be looking ruffular, I suppose.
They do make me want medieval warfare and violence. That's what they make me want. I want to pick up a nice broadsword and just swing and
shit. Something about the strap on the side too, the little buckle here really pushed it over the edge to being photographed by a moat territory with these fuckers on.
These remind me of like a baseball umpire for some reason. I don't know why, but I feel like an umpire when I look at these.
It does say armored. Oh, they're doing the, wow, this is a nice website though. I'm not gonna lie. I'm just
scrolling
down.
Hot. This is a fire website. Whoever designed this, I would like them to do our website. The fuck, man?
Chainmail. Dude, you were right. It is literally chainmail.
Oh God. Okay. Well, yeah. This is made for warfare, y'all. Get your Dracula fighting shoes ready.
Look at
by
this.
Ruffles.
It says the mark. The mark of the ruffle. It's been emblazoned on the back of these shoes here.
Yeah. Not that these were like wearable in the first place, but throwing ruffles on the back in huge letters definitely don't make me want to wear them anymore.
Hold on. I need to pull up a very, very specific image. I need to, you all are going to know exactly what the fuck I'm talking about. Oh, come on. Where is it?
You know what I'm talking about.
Can anyone in the chat guess what I'm about to pull up?
No.
Where is it? How? Why is this so hard to find?
Everybody's saying isopod.
No, it's
some Margiela's ruffle. Any ruffleholics? Mesh babe. Don't say that in this chat. That's bad language.
Oh, I gotta keep looking. Usually I have an immediate
ruffleholics.
Oh, found it. I found it. Okay. Here we go. It reminds me of this meme here. Yeah, that's all I really had to say. Cause you know, like these high resolution Among Us, you know?
With the drip too, don't get it twisted. Oh yeah.
Alright, anyway, that was worth it to pull up, I guess. So yeah, ruffle shoes dropped, and you can wear them near a moat or during siege warfare, I suppose.
Yeah, anytime you guys need to storm a castle or a moat or battle a dragon outside of the Hype Beast convention, there you go. You got a shoe for it.
Hell
now.
Yeah. There you go. I was hoping we would get a poll up on that to see what the vibe was, but we all know the vibe is probably terror, and then four people would vote that they would wear it. So
yeah, we don't even gotta take a poll with y'all no more. We already know what you're gonna do.
Yeah.
I'm hip.
Anyway. Let's just keep blowing through the news, man. We got so much news to talk about, and we have a sudden death coming up featuring AI, so... Oh, this next one. Ooh. 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 Ah. Ah. I'm very excited to see what you all think about this. Remember a couple months ago we told you about the live-action Powerpuff Girls adaptation that was in the works?
Oh, yeah.
We didn't spend too much time talking about it, and I was... You know, I knew everyone would be pissed off about that. But I didn't think people would respond super viscerally to it. Our chat was very upset by the live-action Powerpuff Girls.
It upset me, too.
I kind of forgot about it for a little while. And then, today, live-action Powerpuff Girls to be reworked after campy script allegedly leaks. How campy, you ask? I think we might need to do a dramatic reading of this here.
Yes, yes, yes.
So I have some excerpts pulled up here.
Let's get some examples of how campy.
So, for instance,
Blossom's fine. I saw her on Insta that she has a boyfriend. I saw on her LinkedIn that she got promoted. And I saw on Facebook that she still talks to Grandpa despite their political differences.
And then we got...
Coming back here is probably triggering for her.
MoveOn.org. We also got discussions of leaking nudes here. We got...
I'm not wearing that dress anymore. It's compulsory heterosexuality.
Oh.
Buttercup says, I'm here...
I'm here to pick up bi-curious townies. Oh, you're here to Buttercup. Find Drake. Bubbles is here to investigate, but she forgot Butch hates her. Luckily, we're dealing with another hate boner, so alcohol helps.
The Powerpuff Girls drink? I thought they were like pre-junior high school, like little kids.
It's so much fucking worse, man. There is a full link to the script.
Did they say Drake?
Yes. Yeah. It's really fucking bad. Like I thought everyone was probably overreacting. It's really fucking bad.
This offends me.
So
beyond belief.
Here's one other good excerpt as well. Let me just do a dramatic reading of this.
Blossom heads upstairs where the bumping sound continues from Buttercup's room, then abruptly stops. Blossom opens the door and finds Buttercup in bed with Macy, the woman she eyed at the bar the night before. They've just finished.
And then
the
Macy
Powerpuff
says,
Girls
Macy says
are
she had
fucking.
Six orgasms, six lesbian orgasms, by the way. I feel physically ill.
I don't know if there's too many more things that exist that could make me as uncomfortable as that right there, man. I've been through some shit too, man. I'm talking about like awkward things, arrests. But these last few lines of that Powerpuff Girls movie left me feeling just... Like, what for? Like, why even? Do I have to still even be here anymore? Like, why am I even still trying?
You're dangerously close to just giving up, man.
Why am I even still trying?
Terry, dude, thank you for all these gifts, man. We really appreciate
it. Thank you, Teriyaki.
The problem I have with the Powerpuff Girls rebrand is not so much that they're just necromancing beloved dead properties, because there's no new ideas and late capitalism has to keep lurching forward or else we'll all fall apart for some reason. But it's the fact that they did it in this way. They were like, oh, you know what would be better than excavating and exhuming a rotting corpse of a beloved franchise is if we used a lot of words that we imagine millennials like to say on Tumblr.
Yes. Yes, I think that was probably the thought process, but D-South Honey in the chat got a good point. It's like, why the Powerpuff Girls? Why'd you guys choose them to do this with? This could have went probably with any old, like, franchised cartoon that went out of business. Dude. They could have picked anybody that was a bit more, like, aligned with that type of shit. Like, the Powerpuff Girls never even did this type of shit. Like, they didn't drink and fuck and wait for Drake to pull up.
It's
like,
just because, I bet it's because of 44-year-old advertising executive thought that it would be funny and cheeky because they were little kids before, and now they've grown up and they're millennials just like you. I think that was the vibe.
Didn't they take any type of reference from when the Rugrats tried to grow up? Remember how bad that got and how unwell received that was received? It was pretty bad, man. You should learn by now. Don't grow up a child series. Nobody wants to fucking see that, man. Nobody. Literally nobody. The new kids that have never seen that cartoon, they don't want to see it. And the old kids that grew up watching it, they don't want to see it either. Nobody want to see a grown version of their cartoon characters they grew up with.
Although, that
sucks.
Being said, I would roll the dice on a Hey Arnold all grown up.
I would be scared of that, bro.
I would be terrified.
Do you know how many drugs are going to be getting done? Hey Arnold is definitely inner city artsy show where Arnold will probably find his way to a nice drug circle society.
Arnold will do ketamine on Hey Arnold All Grown Up. I will place money on that if it happens. We also have, dude, you inspired some antagonism in the chat by saying you didn't like All Grown Up. Apparently some of our viewers really enjoyed that.
Hated it, man. It was disgusting.
I never
even
saw it.
Just disgusting. Every episode they were at the mall and like fucking shopping and shit and trying to date somebody. And I'm just like, dog, this is Dill Pickles, man. Like, he's not getting no fucking girls. Like, get out of here, dude. He's fucking Dill. And it just got cringe after a while. So,
well,
I just couldn't do it.
We'll just let the chat tear themselves apart. Y'all don't like All Grown Up. You just think you like that shit. It sucks, says Ice Cream.
It's bad. Rewatch it now, y'all. Rewatch it now with a sober mind and check it out and see what happens. You won't like it.
Anyway, I'm sure that this will not be the last necromanced, reanimated, hobbling corpse of a beloved series that we have to talk about here on the Mystery School stream, because it just doesn't stop. And it won't stop anytime soon, so brace yourselves, I guess.
No, never will it stop. But
that's all we can say.
Yeah, anyway, let's move past that and try to forget that that existed.
Yeah, let's try to forget with one of our favorite fans and friends of the stream, Tyler Ninja Blevins, as he reveals the sad downside to being famous and having money.
Yes. Yes, yes, y'all. Being famous and having money sucks ass so bad. Take it from the number one famous having money guy, Tyler Ninja Blevins, man.
TNB, come on the stream. We know you're out there, man. We would love to talk to you.
Especially about how bad it sucks.
When we see you and your security at Lollapalooza, please tell them to stay away, because we know that we said some things we need to atone for. But, dude, let's just talk about it in private, okay?
Nice.
So, Ninja, man, here he is. The number one gamer rich guy in the world. Famous for doing things such as being a gamer, being rich, being friends with rich, famous celebrities.
Such as?
Drake.
And?
Mr. Sicko Mode himself, Travis Scott.
What? This sounds like a pretty famous and rich guy, man. Yeah. I don't see what the problem is.
He is pretty famous and rich, so let's check out what he had to say about this. During a Q&A with fans, streaming legend Tyler Ninja Blevins opened up about the downsides of fame and wealth. The Twitch star revealed how money can ruin friends and family. Over the last decade, Ninja has become one of the most famous gaming personalities in the world. The former Halo pro has reached heights of celebrity and fame that very few could dream of ever obtaining. Despite his incredible success, Blevins confessed during a fan question and answer segment on May 26th that wealth is not all that it's cracked up to be. In fact, he explained to viewers how money can actually cause a lot of problems in one's personal life. During the Q&A, one fan asked Ninja how it felt to be famous. Not good, he exclaimed before explaining. Mm. Money's great, but even then, money can't buy happiness. Look, there are positives and negatives to everything in life. You guys don't understand. If you have money, 90% of the time or more, you sacrifice a lot. Relationships, family, time, love, friendships. The Twitch streamer followed up and revealed how wealth can also complicate and even ruin close friendships with friends and family. And then you have that money, and guess what? Now you don't know who to trust. You can't trust anyone. Who are your real friends? Who is your real family? As if that wasn't heartbreaking enough.
We got an update from Kia in the chat with a simple, his wife leaving. Oh, okay.
TNB, do you do it? Prayers up for your family in this trying time.
I hope that.
Ninja also told fans how he sometimes is made to feel guilty about his success. People come out of nowhere asking for money all the time, and if you say no, you're a piece of shit, you're the worst, and they make you feel like a piece of shit. How dare you?
Well, sure. You guys heard it here. More money, more problems. Once again, the story goes on, man. It's not cool to be rich or famous, and you heard it here first from TMB himself.
Yeah, you know, it, like, we always have to acknowledge, it's easy to poke fun at Ninja. It's just like, come on, man.
Come on. I would love to just kind of pat him on the back, man. Be like, come on, man.
It's okay,
it's all
right, bro.
Man. It's
fine.
All right, man. Don't worry about just it, man. You'll be okay.
Go to
dude.
A pool party with Drake, you know, listen to Sicko Mode on loop a couple times and get a victory royale, and it's going to be fine. The sun will come out tomorrow, bro.
It's going to be okay, dude. Gotcha. But yeah, there is today's TMB news. Mm-hmm. Make sure you guys stay tuned for any updates on how much more rich and famous he becomes.
We are going to have a problem when we see him in person, inevitably.
I'm going to have a great time. I'm going to just, honestly
sell me out immediately.
Dinner.
Is what you said you'd say that it was
immediately blame everything on you and tell him I had nothing to do with it, man. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't know what he's talking about. I'm your friend, man. If you want to get your security on Owen, then that would be great, man. Because honestly, he's been harassing me and my family recently as well. So maybe we should call the cops.
I remember one time we had someone in the chat who was like, "You guys really are being mean to Ninja." And we're like, damn, bro. I mean,
we were. I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, Ninja. Yeah. Anyway, that's the Ninja news for the day. So I think we can move on to some greener pastures here. Everybody gangster till Tyler Ninja Blevins pulls up with his security, says philanthropist.
I'm definitely turning bitch snitch mode. As soon as he pull up, I'm telling on y'all. I'm telling on him. I'm telling on Twitch. I'm telling on everybody. Like, dude. My hands are up, dude. I had no involvement.
I remember when we were at the Red Bull office in New York in 2018, it was like right as Ninja had started to become so, so famous. And we were there for a meeting and they were like, "Oh, dude, Ninja's here right now." And we could see Ninja's silhouette in like a like a frosted glass window.
It was just a silhouette,
though,
right?
It was his silhouette, and it was like fucking seeing like, you know, in the first episode of like an anime when you see the villain and they're like shrouded in mystery. It was like, oh, there he is, man. Holy shit. We could feel his power emanating.
Yeah, it's definitely like the Smash Bros. Secret character incoming screen, man. He was just standing there with all his Blevins energy, and you could feel it through the glass, man. The ground almost shook when he walked.
Yeah, it was Titanic, man. Dude, they're asking for gambling. I think they are demanding gambling in the chat, actually.
Yes. I guess it is time for a gamble. Let's get you guys one more article, and then we'll hop into today's first gamble of the stream.
Dude, Ray J, it's TOS to rob another Twitch partner. We can't rob Ninja.
No.
Nor would we ever.
We don't even have the faculties to rob Ninja, man.
Dude, he's probably got fucking nanobots and stuff if you pull up on him.
He got real-life Fortnite guys outside his house ready to get a victory homicide if you walk up too close. Catch a victory body on your ass. You don't want that.
Mm-hmm. Yep. He'll wipe out Tomato Town real quick, dude. It's fucked up. Anyway, let's gamble to take our minds off of all of this Tyler Ninja Blevins news here, man.
Mm. All right, so let's get a two article bet.
Okay.
Spice it up a little bit here. All right. Last few times we've gambled, it's been things such as like sun eyewear. I really did like that one.
Yes.
Eyewear was good. I really want to see a Adam's apple. Do we think we can find an Adam's apple?
I would say it's 50-50.
In a throat, that's where they usually reside. So we want to look for an Adam's apple. Next two articles. Do I want to do ads or do I not want to do ads, man?
I say no. Because there's a lot of people and stock photo ass motherfuckers like, in an ad.
Showing those throats. Yeah. All right, no ads. We got article only. Two article bet here. Are we going to see an Adam's apple? We want to look for that in the next two articles.
Fuck two article bets, says Ranger.
No. You got to love two article bets, man. They're always really kind of crazy and hard to gauge.
They're asking about the author. Is the author included?
Always. Author is always included as a part of the article.
Okay. I've pre-opened the next article here. All right. We're good. Mm-hmm. Okay. Run it. Chat, if you want to call in to the Mystery School stream, please hop in the sub-only voice chat section. We're going to prioritize people who haven't had a chance to call in before.
That's right. I would love to talk to somebody nice tonight. Somebody tell us something cool. We're going to go ahead and hop into the Discord and see what we got.
In the sub-only voice chat here. Let's pull her in here. All right. Shanice, you're live on the Mystery School stream.
Oops, I went to the wrong.
How you doing? Can you hear me? Oh, should I have pushed a talk on? Fuck. Definitely can't hear me. Uh-oh. I was raiding in World of Warcraft the other day. There we go.
Brr.
Hey, can you hear me?
Okr.
Hello? Hello?
Shanice? Okr. I'll just go ahead and unmute her real quick. Did that help? Nope. It went back to muted really quick. All right. Well,
We'll just hang out here for a second. You know, maybe she'll come back. Well, like, we still got a minute left in the gamble here, so make sure to throw your points in. Maybe she'll hear us talking. And we had a couple people who got on the call, like, in the bathroom and shit, and then had to run back.
Yes. So. Yeah, that might be the case here. So we'll give a second here while you guys are getting that gamble going, man. Meet the underlord here.
Oh,
this is the underlord.
I have I make you gamble, but
hey guys.
Oh, hey.
Oh my god.
Hey, how's it going?
Yo, what the fuck?
How you doing?
Yo, wait a minute. Do I need to unmute? Hold on. I need to pause you guys on my app.
Oh, okay. Yeah, there we go.
Hey, guys. Yeah, I had a guy pause you guys.
Can you hear us okay?
Good, guys. Yeah, I can hear you guys. Wow, awesome. Hey.
Hey, thanks for calling in.
Thank you for answering. I didn't know how to fucking answer because I'm so new to this, not true to this.
It's all good. It's all good.
It's all good. You're doing a great job right now, though. That's all that counts.
Thanks, guys. You know, I'm really multitasking a lot here. I'm holding my bearded dragon. I'm trying to roll up a blunt. You know, I'm sitting here, like, in my robe looking stupid. I got a lot going on.
A fellow bearded dragon enthusiast here.
A fellow bearded dragon enthusiast. Shout out to Jeff Reed, the bearded dragon.
Man. Yeah.
You know, so anyway, how was your bearded dragon? How old is it? When'd you get it?
I want to say I got it about a month ago. I want to say I don't know how many months he is. But I can post a picture in the Discord. Yeah, he's kind of a baby. He's not a juvie. But he's still a kind of a baby. But he's really socialized. Like, he's really chill. He hangs out with me, you know.
Nice.
He takes a shit on me every now and again. But he chills on me. He takes naps on me and stuff. So I feel
naps and shits. I feel like those are both one and the same right now with baby bearded dragon. They'll do both of those. How you feeling about tonight's gamble? You think we're gonna pull up on any Adam's apples in the next two articles? What do you think?
I definitely feel like we're going to see some throw babies.
Hell yeah.
I definitely feel like we're going to see some throw babies here.
Throw babies.
Hell yeah. Okay.
Yes, I'm thinking so. Well, so far tonight we have,
I
got two more.
Are you guys having a good night?
Yeah, we're having a great night. The stream's been awesome so far.
We're having an amazing night. I got two more good gambles left, and I got one terrible gamble to give to y'all with my new character, the Overlord, the Underlord, actually. He'll be coming through later with a terrible gamble to make everybody lose. But that's going to be a little bit later. For this one, we'll play by the book.
Is there anything that you want to say to us or the Mystery School viewers before we keep it moving here?
Hey, I just want to let you guys know I thank you so, so much for doing this. Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. It's something great to look forward to, especially coming home from work after a long-ass day, or if you had a hard-ass day. It's just awesome to talk to you guys. I just feel like I'm smoking with my homies every time.
Hell yeah.
I hang out with you guys. So I just want to thank you guys for that. You know, Sir Michael Rock, I love you. And Owen Bones, love you too. And yeah, keep doing this shit, man. This shit is fucking awesome. It helps a lot of us out, especially a lot of us that have anxiety and shit. Thank you, because we look forward to this shit at the end of the day.
Thank
I just
want
to let you know that.
Thank you for those kind words.
We appreciate that. No, this shit is always fun to us. We love it, man. It makes our days better too when we're having bad days. We come do the stream and shit kind of just gets better. So I feel you on that. I know exactly what you mean.
Damn right. I love you guys, man. Thank you so much for doing this shit. My bearded dragon's falling asleep over here, so I know you guys are doing a good job. And Let's go.
All right. Thank you so much for calling in. We love you too. Thank you for watching and for the compliments. I'm sure we'll talk to you again soon.
No problem. Everybody roll the fuck up. I'm getting the fuck off. Let's go.
Yeah. All right. Peace out.
Peace out. Peace.
Yes.
Good call right there. Is anybody high in the chat?
Anyone
announce yourself
right now.
Go ahead, post a monkey smoke in the chat. If you are baked, an irresponsible amount, if you should not be around or operating heavy machinery, please post a monkey smoke in the chat.
Absolutely. Absolutely, y'all. Well, that was a great call, and we got a great gamble ahead of us for the next two articles. What do you say, man?
Let's keep it going.
Hop back into it.
Let's keep it going. We got some good news up next. I also see Weast in the sub-only voice chat. We'll pull you in if you want to stick around for the next gamble. We haven't talked to them on the Mystery School stream yet.
Let's go, Weast. I've known
them for a long time. All right, some good news up next after the sadness that was the Blevins fiasco here. Bionic Dog just dropped.
Wow, man. Instantly, I'm getting reminiscent videos in my head about the Doggles article that we reviewed a long time ago where they created a bionic goggle set for dogs to wear during war where they can see and hear and like zoom in and heat vision and shit, and they can lock onto targets with robotic accuracy, man. I think that these additional legs will probably create the most powerful dog we've ever seen in life,
or
man.
It could be like a real RPG party and you get the one dog with the doggles and one dog with the bionic dog legs here, and they can both tackle different operations and shit, which is how I initially imagined this. So
that's sick. Yeah,
let's check out the extent of their power here. Finally, some good fucking news, says Ari Flux. Hell yeah. Oh, I forgot I asked everyone to post their setups in the Discord, and we got some interesting ones that we'll look at during the next gamble as well. Nakio, a mixed breed dog from Nebraska, has finally become the first dog fitted with four prosthetic limbs. This achievement was accomplished by U.S. company OrthoPets, which specializes in artificial pet limbs. However to pronounce your name, lost his limbs and part of his tail to frostbite when he was abandoned in a cellar as a puppy. But now, thanks to a successful operation, he can run and play freely like other dogs. Wow, is that the whole article? Oh, rescued by veterinarian assistant Christine Pace. Put together a fundraiser to raise enough money for the two back prosthetic legs. However, after seeing his condition, OrthoPets opted to do his front limbs free of charge. We got, you know, bionic dog legs here. We can't look at
dog legos.
Any pictures because the website's broken?
Those aren't real pictures, I think. I think those are just like
so
glued onto the page.
Bionic dog dropped.
That is a cool looking dog though. Shit,
yeah,
man.
Cool
I would
fuck.
Definitely want my dog to look like that. Like,
hell yeah.
Hopefully pain free, but definitely loving those bionic legs. That dog looked powerful and fast.
It'd be tight if you get some springs in there so he can really get some, like, you know, action going on, bounce around and stuff.
With that. Yeah, that's tight.
Shout out to the first bionic dog. There are no pictures of Adam's apple, only some dog throat here.
I don't think dogs get Adam's apples though.
No dog apples allowed. Good bionic boy. Oh, shit. This is a two article bet. Oh, also, the author. I pulled up the author's photo here.
Turned around. Well, there you guys go. No Adam's apple in the back of your neck, unfortunately.
No back apple. All right. Well, let's do another quick one here before we keep it moving on. No, smooth neck, Samuel. Rim Cafe owner celebrates birthday in most Philly way. Oh!
Damn, there that neck is. That man is slanging Adam's apple,
apple
right at
alert.
You.
Apple
right
alert.
There.
Apple
yeah.
detected.
Yep, it's right there. He could goop and damn near swallow a whole gallon of milk, man. That is an Adam's apple if I've never seen one.
Throats. We're seeing throats in the chat right now. That is definitely a 100% visible apple right there.
Shout out that man.
Believers, congratulations. Doubters, better get to the refinancing because going to need to win it all back next trade. Let's see. Renee Kobetri's birthday celebration was a record-breaking experience. The owner of Rim Cafe in South Philly invited local chefs to participate in creating a record-breaking cheesesteak 510 feet long that spanned three city blocks. The tasty spectacle embraced international flavors thanks to Philly chefs who each made sections to represent specific countries. For example, Chef Christina Martinez of South Philly Barbacoa created a Mexican cheesesteak. Chef Mike McKinley of Yakitori Boy created a Japanese cheesesteak, and Chef Dion Wijojo, owner of Hardena Restaurant, created an Indonesian cheesesteak, to name a few.
That do look damn fucking all delicious. Of those sounded good as shit. That barbacoa one, the Mexican cheesesteak, I need to know what the ingredients are on that. That sounds good.
I will say, though, even though I'm vaccinated, I don't want thousands of people near a bunch of exposed open-air meat and toppings in like on a city street.
You got me there. Yeah, that's where I draw the line too, man. Just a bunch of random strangers coughing and breathing and talking about the fucking Yankees game over the top of my meat. Loudly, I don't like that.
Loudly exclaiming, pulling down their masks to giving spittle on your Japanese cheesesteak.
Giving thumbs up and like touching my shit. Nah.
Oh, look, he's leaning. His Rolex is centimeters away from wiping on the cheesesteak here, dude.
Why does he not give a fuck about that? That is not a weird thing for him. Oh, look at this dude fucking hand over it. Like, just that boy. Like, boy, what are those all over my cheesesteak?
Oh, God, this is activating my phobias, man.
Imagine being the person. Imagine being, like, the group of people that comes in, like, the last 30 minutes while this is still open before they close the doors for
the
night.
All the touched on international cheesesteaks.
All the picked over pigeon pieces and all the fucking flies.
Dude,
you know
birds are landing up and down this shit midday.
A fly will just, like, touch that and sit on it just for 2 seconds and be like, yeah, whatever, I got my piece. That's all I need. It's just, like, a sit.
Well,
to sit on it.
Cheesesteak, especially international cheesesteak, delicious. Open air, 510 feet of meat in the center
Hell
of a city block. No. No.
No fucking way, man. Look at that. Oh, God. All the exhaust fumes from all of those food trucks and shit just breathing on the food. Shit. I'm good, man. Oh, I don't need that.
This appears to be a communal dipping pot as well that works on the honor system where you can just dunk into your cheese.
Oh, that big fucking 3-foot metal bucket that they just poured a bunch of cheese into. Yeah, this spells a plague part two coming, man. This is why we can't get out of the damn pandemic as it is, man.
That's the vomit bucket, says Yonosaurus Rex.
Don't get it confused with the cheese bucket, because I'm sure some people mixed them up.
Yeah, so very delicious on one hand, very frightening and disgusting on the other hand. Man, I'm conflicted. I contain multitudes in that cheesesteak article right there.
Ain't no conflict there for me, man. I hate it, dude. Like, those sound like good ideas as far as the cheesesteak flavors, but the presentation is just not for me, man. Don't have my shit just outside on a city street.
Something about the fact that it's three blocks long, unbroken line down the middle of a street, flanked by hundreds, if not thousands, of cheesesteak enthusiasts.
Oh, dog, there's apartment buildings above it and shit. Like, people got those air conditioners in your window that's like spitting out water and mystery wet shit. Mm-hmm. All this. Oh, my God. No, sir. No.
Yeah, sorry, Philly cheesesteak party there. I'm not feeling it. Maybe next. No, fuck that. You know, even if there wasn't a plague going around, I still would not be vibing with the open air cheesesteak. I'll just get my personal cheesesteak, honestly.
Yeah, that's worse than like the worst buffet, honestly. Like, buffets are already pretty dangerous, but that's worse than the worst buffet.
Yeah, for real. Chicago guys just mad because they don't have steaks. I mean, we do, but
we
they're not
steaks.
Open air on a city block.
They're not a fucking 4th of July parade of steaks where everybody's marching down in front of Macy's,
all
man. They're just
all touching it communally, you know.
Yelling at it and talking about the sports scores. It's a fucking dinner, man. Like, don't talk to it.
All right, anyway, let's gamble again in another article or two here. We got a product here that may make you run on down to the communal cheesesteak line and throw caution to the wind, because we have Canna Bumps. That's right, weed THC concentrate that you do like cocaine.
Yes, yes.
Oh, God.
Finally, weed cocaine has shown up. I've been waiting for this since the invention of catnip. The logical conclusion of weed cocaine. Snortable weed. I've been waiting for this for decades.
Dude, we're just one step away from tying a rope around your bicep and fucking just mainlining some THC crystals and directly in your bloodstream. It's just one leap away. One little jump away.
I don't even think that'll be the end result of the weed consumption, yeah. Man. It'll probably just start a... What? Honestly, there's nothing after injecting it into your veins. That's probably right. It.
Because people are already doing it through their butts. You got topical lotions. All we're missing are weed needles, dude.
Oh, my God. You know what just hit me? If they keep upping the ante on how weed is consumed, they gonna make this shit re-illegal again if y'all keep on fucking around. Stop this, dude. Man. We just got it legalized.
I'm a weed enthusiast, and I'm about to switch sides to recriminalize weed.
Man, I'm about to vote on it, too, because once I gotta inject my weed into my, like, corner of my eye socket, then I don't want it anymore, right. Man. I want it to be illegal again.
Damn. Well, let's check it out. Let's check out Cannabumps. I'm sure many of you have already seen this on Twitter and shit. A new cannabis product made waves this past week, and not in a good way. Cannabumps, a
snortable
powdered cannabis concentrate packaged to look like cocaine, caught the eye of a few industry leaders. They tweeted their reactions, and pretty much a chorus of so gross, and by the weekend, weed Twitter was piling on. You just get a little spoon with it and, you know, just do some weed cocaine, I suppose. Cannabumps.
Why, man? What do we have to coke our weed for, man?
Cannabumps is made by
THC Living,
a licensed California edibles manufacturer whose product line was previously limited to THC-infused lemonade and pain relief topicals. What party did they go to? What Burning Man event did they attend that made them switch up like this, man?
Yeah, Jesus. Something went wrong.
With 600 milligrams of THC per package, THC Living appeared to legally position Cannabumps as a concentrate. California law allows up to 1,000 milligrams of THC per package for concentrates. Edibles are limited to 100 milligrams. Most way, thank you for those bits, man. Have a great time with your cannabis with our novel cannabis concentrate.
Cannabumps are exactly what they sound like. Cannabis concentrate intended to be devoured through the... Devoured through the nose, ingested straightforwardly, or added to your number one food.
No one's doing it on their fucking food. You just told them to devour it through their
nose, bro. Shut the fuck up. First and foremost, shut up. And secondly, it's only a matter of time before the crack dealers find out about this and start rocking it up and selling it in little red containers, man.
Wow. Okay, by the end of the week, the industry-wide backlash and or the legal peril appeared to have an effect. The product could no longer be found on THC Living's brand pages on either Leafly or Weed Maps. That led to some to speculate on Reddit that the whole thing was one big joke. It's fake, it doesn't exist. Unfortunately, it appears the product does exist.
Unfortunately.
Late Monday afternoon, a law firm representing THC Living released a statement to Leafly that included this explanation. Oh, here we go. All right.
What's the goddamn explanation, man?
A few months ago, our client was approached by a third party. Oh, so they're like, we didn't do it. Some real degenerate fucker told us, hey, dude, what if there was weed cocaine? I already know that that's going to be
the... client.
A client. They sought to utilize our client's proprietary formulations in the creation of the Cannabumps product. As soon as our client learned more about the product, it took the temperature of its customers and those in the industry to gauge how they felt about Cannabumps. Because of its own concerns, those expressed by consumers and the misgivings of those in the industry, our client made the decision to terminate any license granted to any third party that would use its proprietary information to produce or market a product like Cannabumps.
Oh, he's too good for the weed coke now, huh?
Yeah, wow, they switched up. Like, oh no, we would never make weed cocaine. We were just about to lease the formula out to some degenerates that would then make it using our proprietary formula.
Somebody gonna definitely rock that shit up and be serving, man, serving... Yeah. THC by the brick, man.
So mainlining weed directly into your veins is truly the last frontier left. I remember all those memes back in the day in like 2009, 2010, like weed needles. I found weed needles in my son's room. That's probably going to come true eventually. Like, let's be real.
Unfortunately, it is going to come true. Yeah. Oh, and I'm sad to say that, but it will be here sooner than we think. And that will be the day that they illegalize weed. I think we'll lose our weed privileges there. And honestly, we deserve it at that point.
Yo, I'm seeing some jokes about weed crack, runt crystals. You all, I think I talked about this on the stream back in the day. My homie introduced me to this shit in like 2017.
Oh,
THC crystals grown in a lab that sit in a sauce of terpenes.
Oh yeah, I remember this. Mm-hmm. This is intense shit right here.
Yep.
This is, you want to get scary high and almost have to call your mom and like ask her to call the police on you or something.
My homie had this shit. I did not partake because I'm not that I'm not that enthusiastic about being high. And it's like crystals grown in a vat. That are as I understand, scientifically as pure as you can possibly create them. I'm talking like 99.8% pure THC crystallized that then sits in like a runny snot-like sauce. So you kind of like either hit the rock directly or mix it with a little bit of the sauce or something. This is about as extreme. Before weed coke, this was the most extreme weed byproduct I'd ever seen.
Wow. Yeah. The fact that you keep on saying rock and crystal and just rock. Right. I've never associated
lab grown and shit like that.
And terpene sauce. Yeah. I've never associated those type of terms with like just getting high off weed, man. You know, I'm not a boomer or nothing where I'm just like, oh, the weed's too strong. But the weed is too fucking strong, man. Why is it getting crystallized in terpene sauce and snorted through my nose, man? Like, let's just smoke it.
I don't really need that, man. Lord Rockwell says, Owen, have you ever heard of THCA isolate? I've heard of it. I have not tried it, man.
That sounds really scientific and really dangerous.
Do we have any weed rock, like 99.9% purity fucking hot nail doers in the chat that can...
Hot nail
doers! That can, like, really enthusiastically vouch for this product?
You gotta light up the dab rig the night before to get it to the proper temperature.
Turn on the fucking fusion reactor overnight.
Any of those in the chat, let us know, guys.
The diamond. I'm the diamond dabber, says Aggie.
Aggie Panda said, that's me.
I only inject my reefer. Sorry, says Yonosaurus Rex.
Hitting that chaos emerald of weed crystal right there.
The chaos emerald. I never thought we would live in a timeline where fucking dabs are like, oh, that's just normal, like, basic shit. Are you gotta
heat up these crystals on a magnetic coil and inhale them after they've been grown in a lab.
But that's where the kids are at now, dude. You gotta catch up.
If your weed ain't got six different type of terpene sauces drizzled on top of it, then are you really smoking at all?
Search CBD isolate. Okay, CBD isolate.
Are you getting high if you're not drizzling it in THC acid?
This shit definitely looks like a controlled substance. That's
you going to jail, you get pulled over with that. I don't give a fuck what you say.
Back
police are
day,
not about to test shit.
Back
you
in my day,
jail.
We didn't need CBD cocaine, man. A CBD hot dog had you twisted enough. Just eat the CBD corn dog and move on with your day. Jesus.
Jesus Christ.
Oh my God.
Man. We getting high as shit in 2021, man. Let's embrace it, guys. I guess this is the future.
Kids nowadays must have not almost died in a hot box, says Unique. No, dude, it's an age-old tradition that's being phased out by the Zoomers these days.
God damn, man. They do everything better than us, man. They get high better than us. Right. They do every fucking thing better.
Wow. All right, well, actually, we have the perfect article up next. We're going to gamble after this one because this is just the perfect segue I didn't even intend for. We got tonight's title article up next. I am ecstatic, honored, and just all around overjoyed to present you with this breaking scientific research. Lobster hot box. They hot box the lobster, fuckers.
Added a flame and into the hot box, as they say. The lobster is in a fucking controlled bucket, blazing. And I guarantee that whatever he's smoking is probably hitting him like those terpene crystals we just saw, because he's
this
a small lobster.
Lobster has no idea what's going on and is not able to operate heavy machinery at all.
Oh, philanthropist in the chat said, that's a real edible.
Oh, God.
That probably would be delicious. A high-ass lobster cooked to perfection?
Yes, damn. So I looked into this a little bit before the stream because I thought it might have just been a meme going around. The extent of the research seemed to be, do lobsters get high? And the answer is,
what's that guy's face?
Oh, where was it?
Control the speed at which the lobster gets high.
There was an excerpt from the paper that I saw earlier. The short answer is yes, definitely. They got really high. The study said that they started moving around slower and their motor function was poor. So the lobsters get fucked up from being exposed to THC. That's the science of it right there.
Man, I think you put anything in a box that small with that much weed smoke, it'll get high. You can put a damn brick in that
plant
chamber and it'll get high.
Man. Lobster, roll that blunt, brother, says Yonosaurus Rex. Yeah, this is the whole article. Like, there's nothing else to unpack here. They said,
fuck it, lobster vape chamber.
And then did some science and they determined that the lobster got high in the vape chamber.
Fucking sick, man. Out of most animals, I think a lobster would be cool to get high with just because they could actually hold the blunt with their little claws, man. Most animals are on four legs and they can't hold shit because they don't got any thumbs or anything. But a lobster, you give him that motherfucking joint, he'll grip. And hopefully he'll take a nice pull from it and get high with
you. He'll hold on to that. Chat, we do not condone smoking weed with animals here. It's like not a good idea. But in the alternate reality where animals not only love to smoke weed, but it was also great for them, what animal would you want to smoke weed with? I would say, dude, this is my answer for everything. A
fucking capybara, dude.
God, everything is capybara.
Let me take a look.
Return to capybara.
Take a look at this fucking guy and tell me. Tell me to my face that this would not be just a cool, chill-ass dude.
To smoke a fat one with? Yeah.
Damn.
He probably will take you to Jack in the Box after and pay for everything.
Chilling.
Cool dude. Oh, now Google orangutan in there as well, and that's my weed smoking partner. He already looks like he's smoking tons of weed, man. I would love to just sit down and, you know, smoke a fat one with good old orangutan.
I don't know, dude. An orangutan reminds me of the kind of guy who, you know, would be totally nice regularly and then
un-high.
You smoke weed and they start to, like, have paranoid delusions and, like, start to go like this towards you and shit.
Oh, no, that would be terrifying. That would be fucking terrifying, man. I would hate to see a angry high orangutan, man.
Definitely. Trying to smoke with an otter. Young Chef and I fuck with that. Let me scroll up a little bit, see what people were saying. An elephant.
He's doing this.
Adriana says a hedgehog. I'm with it. Koala.
Wouldn't
stay
go
high.
So fast anymore.
A parrot. I'd snort weed with an anteater, says Yonosaurus Rex.
Oh, they probably smoke some good weed. Oh, a dick. Dick dicks are cool looking weird things, man. I like those.
Shout out a dick. I would definitely get, they would get, look at their long neck and get scared if I was too high.
Koalas. No, I don't smoke with koalas. They got STDs, man. They got chlamydia. I don't smoke with koalas.
Yeah, koalas, man, they're going to be sucking on the blunt. You'll have to get tested afterwards. Shit. Wait, who said that? GK Doom says, I'm trying to smoke with a pangolin.
Oh, yeah, that's pretty cool. A leech, Unique says. Leech would smoke the whole blunt and not even pass it to you, man. I don't want to smoke with a leech.
Not passing that shit at all. All right, damn, there are so much fucking news to do. This is such a good problem to have. You know, I said we would gamble, but I think this next article not only relates to the conversation that we're having right now, but we also just need to get through this thematically. So speaking of, woman hops into El Paso Zoo monkey enclosure to feed animals hot Cheetos. I mean, very dangerous.
it has its benefits though.
W's. Gosh darn it.
Whoever said that, I feel you.
Just one lone W in the chat.
That's what I was saying. I was like, it sounds crazy, but there are huge benefits to feeding hot Cheetos to monkeys in the zoo, man.
Such as
legendary status, such as
them
fun.
Enjoying it and their palate, flavor palate being revolutionized so that they can start an uprising.
Introducing
in the zoo.
Them to new things. Mm-hmm. Like, there's tons of benefits to throwing hot Cheetos. Not even throwing hot Cheetos, getting into their enclosure with hot Cheetos.
Yeah, right. Oh, there's a video of it? Oh, that's probably TOS. I don't know if I can show that. We do not condone smoking weed with animals or feeding them hot Cheetos, for the record. A Texas woman climbed into the spider monkey enclosure at the El Paso Zoo over the weekend to feed the animals hot Cheetos, according to multiple reports. An article from ABC7 identified the woman who entered the enclosure as Lucy Ray, someone El Paso Zoo director Joe Montesano described as stupid and lucky in a video posted to Instagram by FitFam El Paso.
I wonder, which monkeys did she feed them
to? Spider monkeys.
Ah, no, they're not that dangerous. Off, right? They're just like, they got long arms, but they're not really that
Ray
scary.
Can be seen feeding the animals underneath a waterfall feature in their habitat before walking back towards the pathway of the enclosure. Laker fan, thank you for that gift, man. I'd play this, but it's going to be really loud and also probably bum everyone out, so I don't know if we should play
it. My God, damn. So she hopped her ass in there through the waterfalls, too? Wow.
Yeah, damn.
That's kind of savage. I don't know, man.
So Montesano told Newsweek that the monkeys are fine, maybe a little shaken up by the incident, but they're fine. He also told publications that zoo officials are meeting with law enforcement to discuss bringing charges against Ray and that they will be pursuing prosecution to the fullest extent of the law.
Damn, now you got a felony for feeding the monkeys flaming hots, man. You could have did some fraud or something, got some money at least before you did it, got your first felony charge.
Why hot Cheetos? I mean, I guess they're tasty and good.
Subjective, but She chose the right monkeys, though. She chose spider monkeys because they are probably the least dangerous to kill you or bite your head off. If she would have chose, like, gorillas or orangutan or chimpanzee, then I would be like, yo, you fucking crazy, man.
Right.
You,
yeah, that's die. Real, like, suicide by monkey type shit right there.
Yeah, like, you're going to die. Or maybe she might be able to coax them into a peaceful interaction with the Cheetos.
JJB Will says, monkeys are probably jonesing for a fix right now. Yeah, after they... Dude, imagine an animal's flavor palate being expanded, tasting all the synthetic poison, yellow five and shit inside of a Flaming Hot, and it like activates their consciousness or some shit.
Those monkeys probably wake up every morning screaming at the top of their lungs and like being bloodthirsty for the trainers every time they come in without a bag of Cheetos.
Their brain chemistry was permanently altered after that shit, man.
Monkey. All right.
Oh my God, actually one more quick article on this subject here. Unathletic alligator with terrible arthritis escapes Wisconsin Zoo. Damn, why'd they have to... He's self-conscious about this shit, man. Don't put him on blast like that. Jesus.
Y'all picking on single unathletic gators with arthritis now? The Hill. This publication needs to be banned, man. Yeah, that was real. That was real lowbrow.
Tell me more about Biden. Ooh, I bet there's Joe Biden updates.
Real low blow right there. Alligator. The Hill. The fuck, man.
Damn, there he and
oh. That boy looked malnourished, though. I ain't gonna lie. The ribs are showing on this gator, man.
Such little arms and legs, too.
They called him... when they said unathletic, I thought it was gonna be just like a big, fat piece of shit gator just laying in the middle of the street. But this is a malnourished, sickly gator, man, with arthritis.
The owner of a Wisconsin zoo is stupefied over how his unathletic and overweight alligator got loose, which was later safely returned. Steve Doc Hopkins at Doc Zoo and Doc's Harley Davidson... It's a hybrid zoo Harley Davidson. Let's
read that again for me because I didn't understand that. I need to put on my thinking.
Doc Hopkins of Doc's Zoo at Doc's Harley Davidson. Damn, dude.
He got a Harley Davidson fucking dealership with a zoo inside of the Harley Davidson dealership.
Steve Doc Hopkins. And he named the place after himself. So it's Doc's Harley Davidson Zoo. So it's motorcycles, leather vest, leather pants, helmets, and a fucking koala and fat alligators all around.
This is probably an interesting ass dude. Also, one of the most Wisconsin things I've heard recently. So shout out to Wisconsin.
Damn, I'd love to hit a terpene soaked THC crystal and walk into this zoo and just trip out.
Imagine
and be like, whoa!
One moment you're looking at pristine Harley Davidsons, you go through a sliding glass door, and you're in the fucking zoo.
I'd take a can of bump or two before walking into there so I could trip out and really ride a motorcycle and ride a fucking giraffe.
Let's
who knows?
Anthony in the chat says, shout out to my big booty friend. Agreed.
Okay.
The four animals kept in the zoo's outdoor pen, only one, Rex, escaped. We came to feed the gators today and one of them was missing. There was no sign of the enclosure being breached in any way or the gator digging underneath or anything. It's just very strange. This has never happened before. He added, the only thing I can think is maybe he was pumping iron all during COVID or something and planned the escape. I don't know. So he got returned. He's fine. But damn, they did him dirty with the headline.
Yeah, I bet all his lady friends is definitely like,
man, bro, are you the unathletic gator with arthritis that escaped, Ronald? Is that you? Because I could have sworn you were a little bit faster than that.
They had
to
bring him back into the pen and just get ridiculed after that shit.
Wow, poor dude, man. Hate to be him, but I'm not, so sucks to be that alligator.
Sucks to suck, I guess. For Love of Rage, he says, I'm at the Reptile Zoo. I'm at the Harley-Davidson shop. I'm at the combination Reptile Zoo Harley-Davidson shop.
That's a mind fuck right there, man. I would like to see that. I'm going to Google that after the stream and see if I can find some like 3D tours or imagery of what that place looks like. Because I think I got a good idea.
All right, man. They are uprising in the chat. I think we need to gamble more.
All right. I get it. Yep, it's time. It's about time. It's time for a gamble.
I checked the Discord. There's not really any new gambling suggestions in there that I've seen.
Not really.
I saw a couple people spam the reading bet. They want me to do the reading bet again. I'll let you decide, man. Whatever you think the right gamble is here.
Let's let Alien do a gamble right now.
Oh, God. Okay. All right.
When's the last time you guys let Alien give you a gamble? All right. I'll give you an intergalactic gamble for the ages that you'll never forget.
Tight.
Let's have a three-article gamble here. Mm-hmm. And in the spirit of space travel and exploration, Let's see if there will be any type of... Will there be any type of electronic screens in the next three articles?
Wow, that is a very intergalactic bet.
Yes, we did bring, we brought iPhones from space to you all. We brought you guys computers. We brought you Wi-Fi, cryptocurrency.
Those
we brought
Leapfrog
you
tablets.
We brought you Leapfrog tablets. And we brought you Cannabumps as well from space. These are all space inventions.
Makes
so
a lot of sense, honestly.
We'll see if we can find more in the next three articles.
Okay.
We need a screen. We're looking for an electronic screen, cell phone, computer, television, you name it. It has to be a screen visibly
count.
Shown.
Do ads count?
We will. We'll allow ads. We'll allow ads for this one because I am a kind alien that is trying to give technology to the Earth.
Okay, fair. All right, Gamble coming up in just a second here. Weast, if you want to go ahead and unmute yourself, let's have you call in. When I see you unmute, I'm going to pull you into the on-air channel here. Jesus Christ. All right. I heard from Dog the other day, alien.
Ah, yes. Your Earth air is giving me a quite the reaction right now. I'm breathing it in, and it's really tripping me out, so I need a little help.
Dude, I heard that Dog is going to be back soon. Have you met Dog at all?
My best friend Dog, my arch nemesis Dog, who knows, were we friends or enemies, no one will ever figure it out, but I have a special place in my heart for Dog.
Hell yeah, Dog's coming back to the stream soon, don't worry.
Awesome, I'm awaiting his return.
We're going to pull Weast into the stream. Weast, you're live on air, how are you doing?
I'm doing fantastic, how are y'all?
I'm doing great. We know each other in real life.
We do.
Is it the real Weast?
This is true.
It's been a little while since I've talked to you. How are you doing?
I'm doing really good. I have my 31st birthday actually on Friday, and
what? Happy early birthday!
Happy early 41st birthday, dude! If you're 31, you're 41. So congrats, man!
Thank you. I've just been out here in Iowa, moved from Chicago to be closer to family, and
nice.
Yeah. It's not gonna lie, real fucking mixed bag. I can't complain. Things are going good.
Awesome. That's great. Great.
We've
seen you in the Mystery School chat often. You've been a day one supporter of Mystery School and a day one supporter of me. We've known each other since I had just began my artistic journey. Do you have any reflections or comments to share about the Mystery School stream and everything that's going on these days?
I got to give a massive shout out to Stales McGales. I don't know if she's in the chat tonight, but she is the one who technically linked us in the first place all those years ago. And I just want to say that, like, even before you were, like, getting heavily into streaming, I knew that, like, we had lots of conversations just, like, just hanging out while you were, like, producing and making beats and just, like, shooting the shit. And like you have had this format like in your blood for so long, and it makes me so happy to see you two linking and doing this. It's so natural, it's so good, it's so wonderful. Like I it makes my heart sing to tune in, seriously,
man. Thank you, Weez. I appreciate the compliment as well, man. Fuck, dude, it's good to just have people that have known either him or me in real life sometimes come on the stream and see it and like experience this, because as we started this, like, this shit didn't make any sense, and we had no idea what we were about to engage in, man. We just wanted to like somehow talk to people and connect with people on a consistent basis that wasn't Twitter or Instagram and shit, man. So I'm glad to, you know, be a reason for you to pull up so often since we've started this, man. Like it's been fucking fun.
Absolutely, it's all love, guys. It's always great to talk to y'all.
Dude, likewise, same your way. We love you. Thank you so much for supporting the stream and just coming, shooting the shit and chat with us. We really appreciate it.
Thank you, man. Appreciate it, bro.
Yeah, have a good night. Yo, and real quick before I go, Italian Owen Bones, the truth is out there.
Oh,
hashtag Italian Owen Bones.
Hey, what? We're trying to suppress this. All right.
What is this?
The call has mysteriously disconnected. The call is mysteriously disconnected. Weast, thank you for calling in. I've known Weezed since like I had just started becoming an artist, and they've always been there supporting my career and stuff and just being a friend to me.
Awesome.
So I really appreciate them still watching the stream.
The Italian Owen Bones. Yep, we've got quite the expose here. We're going to have to figure this out as a community, everybody. Go ahead and Google that and drop it in a Discord for us and see what you can pull out. I think we got a bit more intel on the Owen Bones ethnicity here that we've been searching for, y'all.
Keep feathering it in the chat says,
cooker to meatball.
Oh, he cooked a. Yes, he does.
All right. Well, on that note, let's just crush all conspiracies here and keep moving on to some breaking news for some of our viewers. Study shows people working from home are having sex, dating, taking naps, and doing side hustles on company time. You know what they say? Boss makes a dollar, I make a dime. That's why I have sex, date, take naps, and do side hustles on company time.
That's right. That is the new millennial way of fucking the man right there.
Yeah.
If you're working from home, guys, have set up. Oh, instantly we got a screen right there. Damn. Technology has found us once again, everybody. Let's pay out the bet.
Sorry, were you going to say have sex at home to fuck the man?
Yes, I was, but I see how that's like a double entendre right there. I like that.
The official stance of the Mystery School stream on matters of late capitalism is have sex at home to fuck the man, okay?
Damn.
That's all you really
on the company dime. That's what you got to do it as, man.
Yeah. All right. So I guess, you know, in surprising exactly fucking no one, everyone is doing things other than working for a lot of the time when they're working at home.
Love it.
So let's see. Americans are excessively eating, drinking, smoking pot, playing video games, and watching porn while quarantined. At the beginning of the COVID-19 outbreak, there was a heated debate about what people should be doing. Some said that this was a time for self-care and just focusing on making it through one day at a time. Others ascribed to the hustle porn mentality.
Hustle porn.
Never heard
that.
Not
familiar with that one.
Makes sense, though. Saying you should get up early, work out, learn a new language, and read 10 books a day. Yeah, any hustle porn enthusiasts in the chat.
That's why I didn't know about hustle porn, because I don't do any of those things.
We have just one lone Gary V in the chat from Uzi Convertible.
Is he a hustle porn actor or something?
Real hustle porn enthusiast there.
Hustle porn star?
After conducting research into the activities of the self-quarantine to determine if they were diligently working hard at home or engaged in extracurricular activities, the results were that Americans drank heavily, smoked copious amounts of weed, played video games, ate lots of junk food, and watched television, Netflix, and porn more than ever before. A study from the Nielsen Corporation, a nearly 100-year-old marketing research and ratings firm, revealed alcohol sales were up 55% in the week ending March 21st. It found the amounts of spirits sold, such as tequila, gin, and premixed cocktails, skyrocketed 75% compared to the previous year. Wine sales rose 66%, beer sales popped 42%, and online alcohol sales grew by an astonishing 243% from last year at the same time.
Yeah.
Marijuana sales were up.
Should have invested in alcohol coin last year. Right. You would have been a millionaire right now.
Hell yeah. What about the... So a recent study commissioned by Econologist conducted by ZDNet captured the current zeitgeist of our working from home activities. 42% have been on a date. 41% have had sex. Almost half say they've had an alcoholic drink. 60% have taken a nap. An overwhelming 77% say that they shop online while on the clock at least once a week. 50% of correspondents have worked for another company while on the clock with their employer.
Now that, I love that. That's sick right there.
2 in 5 have been reprimanded at least once for getting off task, and 39% of people have been let go from their jobs for doing non-work-related activities. Despite 76% of respondents spending more than 4 hours each day focused on work, 40% of participants said they spend 4 or more hours away from their computers.
Wow.
Yeah, sure, dude. I mean, not only... understandable, but also good.
Very good. And this brings me to a new thought that, like, pretty soon, y'all, and this is honestly a good thing too, pretty soon our quarantine pandemic way of life hopefully begins to kind of taper off a little bit as the world becomes more and more vaccinated and the daily cases begin to drop more and more. It just lets me know that It's going to be a lot of people getting in fucking trouble once everything is like back to more normal.
Dude, when you go back
you
to your cubicle job,
you can't do the same
just,
shit that you've been doing over quarantine.
You go back to your fucking cubicle job and start smoking a joint and jerking off. You're going to get a call from HR right away.
Eating it, jerking off, and calling your grandma on FaceTime like, hey, grandma, I'm at work. I don't give a fuck. I'm working from home, and you're not working from home anymore. So we got to make sure that we like start to wean ourselves off of our quarantine habits that we've picked up, guys, because they're going to expect us to go back into the real world and be adults pretty soon, man. And it's not seeming like it's going to be an easy transition.
Dude, Slopterbox, thank you for all these gifted subs today.
Slop, he's thank you, Slop.
Throwing them like singles right now. Thank you so much, man.
Oh, we got Alone.
Appreciate that.
Alone Nah in the chat from Maggie Panda. She is there. We'll never be able to go back to the same way that we were having like our quarantine work from home sessions, man. Yeah. It's not feasible. These bosses and CEOs are going to be angry at us off and smoking weed on the job.
Plenty of them will adapt. Plenty of them will be like, yeah, sure, you can work from home. But most of them will be like,
no, you must come take place in capitalism in one centralized location.
So we'll see. We'll
that's gonna suck. Gonna suck, but at the end of the day, a pandemic sucks way more. So I would rather, maybe we don't get to jerk off as much, but I would appreciate if we didn't have a deadly virus circulating as well.
Absolutely. I agree. Live from the Glove says,
IDK, I'm stuck in my ways.
Well, watch out. Anyway, let's keep it going. We got some more home activities here. Speaking of easing out of the habits we picked up during the pandemic, we have some advice here to help you get back on your feet as you re-enter the world, such as a handheld grater will make guests want to have sex with you. The anatomy of a grown-up apartment.
So that's what I'm missing. That's where I'm not getting sex with my guests. I have guests over all the time, and they never have sex with me, and I think I know why.
Yeah, man, I have been missing a grater my entire life, and this explains a lot, actually. So let's check out some of these suggestions. So are you a normal, well-adjusted adult out in the world? Well, you better have all these things on your checklist, okay? Let's figure it out. Uh-oh, Big Baby Says has two handheld graters. Got to beat the potential sexual partners away every time he leaves the house. So a plant. Okay, check. I do have several. I have a plant right here, actually, a rather large plant.
I got zero plants inside. I got two fake plants, but I think that people know the difference, and they're not going to fuck me for those, so that's probably why.
Okay, so we got plants. So I'm one for one. You're 0 for one so far. A handheld grater to shave delicate slices of Parmesan. I do not have one of those. Chat, keep count how many of these you have, okay? Or else you may never have sex again. So no handheld grater here. Ratham, dude, welcome back for 28 months. Holy shit.
What's up,
Ratham? One of our oldest subscribers right there. Thank you for your support, man.
Ratham is
that.
Indeed 90 years old. Our oldest subscriber per capita.
A candle. Open flames make guests feel relaxed, and candles make them feel extra relaxed. Anyone have a candle at home?
I got a fucking skull in here.
Oh, that's not a candle.
Is that why I'm not getting sex, man? I got a skull in here.
And
I got
a fake plant and the skull.
Fake plant skull. Shit. I got a PS4. It's not even PS5.
Oh, God, dude.
Fucking, like, there's a bearded dragon, like, heat lamp in here. I bet that scares all about, the sex away.
How about an artisanal ceramic plate?
I might as well just quit now, man.
What, a drink cart? Tell me you at least have a drink cart.
Dude, I just got this glass in here, man. That's about all I fucking got. I don't know what else to...
What about a cream-colored rug with boobs drawn on it?
Now that I have something close to. I do have a cream-colored rug. Titties not included on it, but...
You know, a Sharpie could change that.
I could draw some titties on it. That's no problem.
A piece of art that is sort of mocking you.
Oh, yeah, I got this. Hold on.
I actually do have one of those.
Hold on, let me grab it real quick. Let me show you.
Yeah, dude, I'll show you. I'm going to get my favorite piece of art, too. Hold up. This is my favorite thing. One of my favorite work of art that I own. It's hard to see because the green screen's cutting in. I got this for $9 at a thrift store, like a destitute thrift store in Michigan. It's like horribly fucked up and broken, and it's a really bad print of three dwarfs fighting on a mountain.
That is certainly mocking all of us in real time, man.
I keep it right next to my desk, hung on the wall.
Now, me, I got this, man. And I don't know if I could specifically call it art, but I feel that there's artistry here, and it mocks me every time I look at it. It is a neon peace sign right here,
yes.
Which, hold on, let me see if I can.
Oh.
This definitely mocks the shit out of me every day because I have no peace in my life.
Oh.
So I look at this peace sign, and I'm like, damn, peace, damn, what's that? I'll never have that. And then I get sad again. So there's that. I'll just throw this on the ground over there.
Dude, we have a couple more shots here, such as soap made with Australian native plants. Like,
whoa,
eucalyptus, maybe?
I got
some eucalyptus soap.
Oh,
I think you got that one.
I think I got that one. Oh, a record player. I got a record player.
And what about a spare room?
No, spare as far as just a room that's unused?
I guess so.
No, I don't have a room that's unused. No.
All right, chat. So if we don't have all of those things, we're essentially going to die loveless.
I'm trying to figure out how to get the sex here. So I need an empty room with nothing in it. I need art that makes fun of me. I need artisanal plate. I need a book of some sort, because I don't know how to read, so I don't have that.
I wish I had a spare room, since Kango. What if it's a crawl space? Close enough.
Oh, candle and boob rug. I do got a rug that I can turn into a boob rug if I get a Sharpie. So
okay,
I'm not doing too bad, but I'm not doing too good either.
All right, Chad, it's time to vote, to take our mind off of all this shit that's going on here. What's next? What type of articles do you want next? What's next? We got more BS or Method Watch. It's almost time for Sudden Death, so we kind of have to.
We did unlock Sudden Death today too. That's amazing.
Yeah,
I'm proud of you guys.
Our time here. I'm gonna let you vote with bits if you want.
I gotta think. What kind
of shit.
Article is this?
Well, I set the channel points requirement actually really low on accident. So.
Nice. Well, you guys can just go ahead and...
So cast your vote. What kind of shit are we going to talk about next? We got a couple Method Watch articles. Some pretty good ones, I would say. And we got a bunch of BS left over. They're equally good, honestly.
BS is in the lead right now. Method Watch, not too far, but I think people are edging towards that BS, man. They just want to see it.
I accidentally set the channel point requirement super low, so you might have to start voting with your channel points, everyone, because I think some whales are going to, like, totally dominate the bet here. It's up for just 20 more seconds.
Any excuse for y'all to spend those channel points and donate them right back to the over and under lord.
Yes, both lords are present. BS is skyrocketing in the lead right now. If that wins, then I'm gonna pick just the one best Method Watch article.
It's gonna win. Yeah, it's just running a race on the Method Watch right now.
There
I
are
think
some
BS
good
is
ones.
Winning.
Okay, damn. We can save some of them. All right. Okay, more BS is the winner. I understand. I hear you, chat. I'll respect this. So, how about this one? Nasty rum style, I see in the chat from Markov. Mosway says, I got my first hand job in 5 years today. And then Markov
Damn.
Said, nasty rum style.
Good fucking memory there, man. Congrats there. And, happy anniversary coming up pretty soon.
Happy grip-iversary, I suppose. Congrats, dog.
Hand-iversary.
Hand-iversary, yeah. Okay. Speaking of jerking yourself off, bodybuilder who divorced sex doll is now in a threesome with doll he considers sister.
I don't know how long you guys been watching the Mystery School stream, but if you've been around long enough, you should recognize this character here.
Yep.
This guy has been in, I think this is probably his second.
His third time, dude. We covered.
Third.
So there were two other parts of this saga. First, he started dating the doll. He's like at least a somewhat famous guy. Next, he breaks up with the doll. We last covered that in November of last year.
Relationships are fragile, man.
We lost track of what he was doing, and now he's back. And he's, I guess, in a polyamorous relationship. I'm just checking to make sure none of these dolls have their boobs out or anything.
Yeah. Relationships take work, man. They take two people really maintaining the integrity of it. And it looks like his old relationship kind of... fizzled out, and he moved on to something new.
So let's check it out. Yuri Tolochko, the bodybuilder from Kazakhstan who went viral for marrying a sex doll, has revealed that he is in a threesome with two other dolls now. Yuri, professional bodybuilder. Oh, there we go. He claims that one is half chicken, and he considers the other a sister.
I'm sorry?
One of the dolls he considers half chicken.
Like the poultry, the food?
I'm assuming so.
Like Bok Bok or?
Yeah, Bok and Gok Gok in this case. So anyway, Yuri went viral in 2020 after he announced that he had tied the knot with a sex doll named Margot. He got married to his silicon partner in November 2020. He was in a relationship with Margot for over 8 months before he popped the question. Mm-hmm. Months later, Margot broke down and was sent for repair. Now, that's an interesting double entendre. She broke down and the relationship ended, but she also literally broke and had to go get a repair.
Oh, nice. Wow.
Anyway.
Yeah, nice. We're nailing them tonight.
Yuri went on to reveal that he cheated on her with a different object while she was in the repair shop. Last month, Yuri announced that they were divorced and introduced his new partner, Lola, to the world. Let me introduce you, my new wife. This is Lola. Lola queer. She has not yet decided on her sexual and gender identity. We respect that. She is in search, he wrote on Instagram. He added, we broke up with Margot. I'm not ready to talk about the reasons for the divorce yet. And now, Yuri has introduced another doll who has been named Luna. When Yuri's fans pointed out that she looked incredibly young, he ensured that she is of legal sex doll age and welcomed
come
her.
Come on, man. Don't do this to me right now, big dog. Big dog, don't do this, man.
Oh, man. So most of you suggested giving her the name Luna. I decided to heed your advice, and I will call her Luna. Also, some of you thought she was too young. Although Luna is an adult, she just looks like that because she... Oh. He also, the last thing he said was, I'm not going to stop. I want to get a harem. Hey, you voted for this, okay? We could have just done the method watch, but you wanted more bullshit, so here we are.
Welp.
Can a bump alert, says Live from the Club.
Yeah, maybe we should all just take a can of bump right now to ease the stress that we just endured, man. Let's just all take a can of bump as a group, just so we can calm down and even it back out, man. Come back down to earth.
Okay.
Mellow out a little bit, man.
He clapping robot cheeks. Just
he is getting ass on a robot level. Yeah. He is definitely like the Jason Derulo of robot land,
The Trayson Derulong.
The Trayson Derulong of robot sex, man. He's fucking left and right, but he's beginning to cross a line that I don't know if he's ready for, man.
Can so one of our viewers who's skilled in photo manipulation create the mashup creature of Jason Derulo and Trey Songz that we've come to know as Trayson Derulong? If you can create like a Photoshop of that, I'd really like to see it, please.
Khufu94 in the chat just gives us a solo. Gotta hit the pin. You gotta get high after that, dude.
I don't blame you, honestly.
You gotta get high after hearing that. I understand, and you should. Yeah, that's fair.
We get it. Okay, we need to do a very quick method wash today because there are some really good methods here to cleanse our palate and wash out our eyes from that last one.
My palate is disgusting.
Yeah, my palate is terror at the moment.
I need a cleansing, man. Please.
Trayson Derulong has broken me.
We know.
That was Liam James who invented Trayson Derulong. That, like, I'll wake up in a cold sweat and hear that name echoing in my mind's eye, man. It's too fucking
And
good.
It's too accurate, yes. Too. Like, I could just imagine the Vegito or the Gogeta of Trey Songz and Jason Derulo morphing into one, man. And it scares me.
Liam James
night.
Says Trayson Derulong cannot come to life. He's too strong.
He is incredibly strong, so yeah, we would all be in trouble. All
right, they're doing the fusion dance. Anyway, quick method here. Drop some method emotes if you want. The first invisible sculpture sold for 15,000 euros. The artist Garau, a concentrate of thoughts. Dude, this guy said this was the next frontier on Monday's stream. It was only a matter of fucking time until people were selling ideas. And this dude sold an idea. And I think it's kind of cute that he's like painting around it and shit. That's pretty, you know, he's really selling the bit here.
Wow. We hit the fucking future, y'all. We got, let's go down the line of all the futuristic things we experienced tonight. We got canna bumps. We got cocaine weed now you can sniff.
Yes.
We have, there's weed you can dip in sauce, terpene sauce, and it turns into crystals. We got that. We got, they're selling NFT invisible sculptures now, guys. PlayStation 7 is coming out soon. The future is here, y'all. We might as well just embrace it.
The scamming is in the present, though. So let's check out what happened here. Can nothing be a work of art? According to Salvatore Garau, yes, and obviously also according to those who bought his latest work. The artist, originally from Santa Guista, has created an immaterial sculpture, completely invisible, entitled I Am. If some layman can have doubts about its artistic value, they will have to change their mind. The work was sold for 15,000 euros in the auction organized by Artright, one of the rare Italian auction houses that deals with sessions dedicated exclusively to contemporary art. The work must be placed in a private house within a space free from any obstruction, with dimensions of approximately 150 by 150 centimeters. Estimated at the start of 6,000 euros, it has doubled the base, reaching at the hammer 12,000 euros. Physically, the buyer will find only the guarantee certificate in his hands. This was a translated article, which testifies to the archiving of the work and represents the only visual element present in the catalog, where instead of the traditional image of a tangible work, a absolute white space. Okay, I don't need to be a rocket surgeon to understand that they're saying it's fucking nothing and you get a certificate that says there's nothing there. Yes.
This worse than an NFT.
This is so much worse than an NFT. At least an NFT, you get a fucking JPEG or something, man. With this, he's like, oh, yeah, sorry, you get a fucking certificate for nothing.
Damn, I am selling the wrong drugs, yep. Man. Mm-hmm. I need to start selling invisible shit.
Yeah.
Why haven't I been... I'm about to try it out. I think I might be able to sell this invisible idea
Dude,
that I have.
You
I think
thought
that it
of
really
this
shocks
first.
The masses.
You talked about this on the stream extensively, and we just talked about this on Monday.
I think I'm gonna sell the first inaudible song.
Oh yeah, just some fucking silence.
3 minutes, 30 seconds of inaudible.
Can I produce
gold.
It? Can I produce it at least?
Hell yeah,
okay,
dude.
Chat.
I think we can honestly bring in as many producers as we need for this one, man.
I'm going to say fucking Jetson Made It is on there. Kenny Beats co-produced it too.
I might get a feature from the baby on this one,
Chat,
man.
We're going to start the bidding at one Ethereum. If you want to lock in your bids on the first non-audible song, you can own a piece of history.
Yeah, I think we're onto some shit right here, man. Let's keep this close to the chest. If you guys can keep this a secret and not spread it on the internet, we'd appreciate it, because I think this will be the way that Mystery School hits their first $1 million contract.
Right. Yeah, we're on the way. We're on the way. So thank you for that method. What was this guy's name? Garau. Dude, just keep scamming in the free world, bro. Good, great idea. Excellent idea. Real Virgil method right there.
No, don't let Virgil hear this, man.
Yeah, actually,
if he hears this, we're fucked,
dude.
Man,
Virgil's
so
about to sell hella invisible shit.
Oh my god, I honestly am scared of that. I think that he is about to do that next, dude. Like, if that happens, then I'm gonna have to really just get my hat
if
in the
he
game.
He says something about you're actually buying like the negative space, and in capitalism, negative space is more valuable than the material space, and that actually has more value. I'm gonna go fucking Joker mode, dude.
My God.
It's going to happen. It's going to happen. We got to beat him to the punch, man.
We got to stop talking about this, dude, because I'm getting actually scared, because this is really about to happen, dude. Like, I think that there will be a Virgil Abloh-type character that's about to start selling negative space, negative fashion, negative music, negative hear, like, all types of sounds and shit. Like, this is about to go crazy, man. I'm getting scared.
So, chat, there's some alpha leak for you. You are both eerily correct this week. All right, well, dude, we need a palate cleanser from that article. We're getting a little bit too mega mind here. I think we need to bring it back down.
I don't want
to
share this
to Earth. Let me present to you this next. What the? Trips Ahoy, marijuana munchie man makes wrong turn while wanted for strangulation.
Let's go ahead and just.
Okay. Let me hold on.
Rewind that one. Let's read that again.
Trips Ahoy. Marijuana munchie man makes wrong turn while wanted for strangulation.
Let's start at the top here.
Okay, so marijuana munchie man, we can only presume he was selling marijuana munchies.
So that is his first felony charge right there. Then we got he made a wrong turn.
So presumably we have to assume that he was maybe apprehended or pulled over for a driving related crime. And he was also wanted for strangulation.
Got that. And, yeah, he strangled someone as well. So this person has 3 felony charges and is selling things such as Cannaburst and Trips Ahoy and cheat.
Regular Doritos here. I don't. How see is
he just? He just mixing up like regular chips and weed chips and selling them at the same time.
I think
like,
he's just putting the cannabis cocaine in here. That'd probably be the easy way to shake it around in the
dust. Yeah, just shake up the bag of Doritos. Yeah.
A marijuana munchie man. Is that a term? The munchie man?
Any of our Florida men in the chat, let us know if that's a term that's being used in Florida as of late. I haven't heard that one. I used to live in Florida.
Wow. A marijuana munchie man wanted out of Orlando for attempted kidnapping and strangulation made a wrong turn in Martin County while making his deliveries.
Yeah.
God, I'm on the edge of my fucking seat for this article, man. What's going to happen here?
What's next?
He also had outstanding warrants. When deputies attempted to a traffic stop on the car he was driving, he bailed out on foot, jumped into a pond, and began swimming. God, this one just...
Let's fucking go. He jumped into a pond?
It wasn't enough that 33-year-old Manuel Mustelier was transporting THC edibles and LSD through Martin County, Sheriff William Snyder said. He was fast, but our deputies were faster. He paddled all the way to the other side of the pond where he was taken into custody. Back at the car, deputies located a large box of goodies. A closer look at the package gave them a better idea of why he was in such a hurry. In addition to the LSD, he had more than 29 pounds of THC edibles sealed in packages that often appeal to children. Oh, they tacked that one on. The Trips Ahoy flavor was the biggest clue as to the package's actual content, but that's not all. He was wanted on warrants out of Orange County for attempted kidnapping, battery by strangulation, trespassing on a construction site.
What the fuck,
and resisting arrest. He was arrested and charged with possession and obstruction of justice without violence. He didn't choke anyone to death. He just choked them.
Yeah, I guess he just did a quick Homer Simpson, but...
And then got... That's a very specific charge.
I'm mostly concerned with the trespassing on a construction site charge. Like, what the fuck was he doing on a construction site unauthorized without a hard hat and the proper equipment?
Wow. Chad, that one was...
He need to go to jail. He's a fucking menace. You're right, Kango. That like anybody something. Trespassing on a construction site is dangerous enough to harm you. So,
Ariflex says that got me feeling like I'm tripping. Yet there were many trap doors in that article there that I'm still reeling from, honestly.
Trap Dad with a very logical point here. He said
he looks musty too.
good. You got to point
Does
that out
a
as
Cuban
well.
Cuban link tattooed on him. Hold on.
Hmm. Enhance? Yes.
And it says,
we got a Cuban link tatted with...
It says Cuban.
Does it say Cuban on the chain as well?
It says Cuban
and
on the chain as well.
If you go up to his sternum, there's a Maybach Music label. A Maybach Music emblem right there as well. Man. I don't think I've heard of this artist on the Maybach Music roster online either, so there's a lot of questions left there as well. A
lot of questions. Very few answers here tonight on the Mystery School stream. I'm sorry for that, chat.
Josh Bruff said he got a Cuban link.
Yes.
He definitely got a Cuban link for sure.
Holy shit. Okay.
He got a Maybach Music link as well on his chest because he signed.
Wow. All right, everyone. There were somehow even more articles that we were going to talk about tonight that were equally depraved.
We shouldn't. But we shouldn't talk about anything else tonight.
We really shouldn't because at this point, you know what time it is.
It's time for sudden death.
Yes, that's it, y'all. A full song made from scratch, live in under 30 minutes. You choose the topic. We make the sounds and the raps. What else do you want, man? We got 30 minutes. It's scary.
What do you want from us? I think we're going to do our best to work in another one of the AI rappers today as well. Mm-hmm. So I think, chat, make sure to take a look here. I got the link in the chat. Pick your favorite voices, the features that you want on tonight's Sudden Death track, and we'll try our best. We'll try our best. Hank Hill, it didn't really work out last time, but we're going to try, okay?
If you are watching on a desktop right now, does this point to your chat? Am I pointing
on
to your chat right
now? On the
desktop
it does, yes.
Nice. That's what I wanted.
Oh my God. Ariflux posted a photo of Sonic the Hedgehog's penis in the meme section here.
What's that look like? Let me get a look. I'm going to the Discord real
really,
quick.
Really long.
Nah, not Sonic.
There is also a Sonic the Hedgehog option. So, chat, if you're new here, here's what's going to happen. We're about to go over all the news articles that we talked about on the stream tonight. And you get to pick your favorite three or four, depending on how many good ones there are. We will put them into a poll, and whichever option wins that poll, we're going to make a song about in under 30 minutes. So let's go over everything that we talked about tonight live on the stream, and keep your favorite ones in mind. Put them in the chat when you see them.
I didn't see the Sonic dick, though. I was lied to.
What's
I was
in
really
the memes,
looking forward to
the
that.
Meme section.
Ah, okay, there we go.
We got Cursed Candy collabs here.
Yeah. Yeah.
Ye old Ruffles shoe.
There we go. Mm. Now you're talking, man.
Ye old drip again? I'm fucking with that one, man.
I haven't done a ye old rap yes. in a minute, man. I'm looking forward to a ye old rap.
Ready
Let's
for
see what that's
ye
about.
Old rap. Let's go.
So ye old drip. All right.
We got extremely cursed reboots.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I think we can get into that too. That okay. that could have some potential.
All right. Fair enough. Ninja suffering from success.
Honestly, that's not bad either, man. Ninja suffering with the DJ Khaled holding his
yeah,
forehead
right.
fucking picture. That'd be good.
Bionic Dog.
Okay.
Disgusting public fucking Philly cheesesteak spitting sneezing.
Public. Let's say public public food.
Like, terrible buffet. Scary buffet. Yes. We got hardcore weed.
Oh, weed extreme.
Extreme weed. I like extreme weed.
Yeah. Okay, that's an option.
Hot lobster hotbox. There's
just
so many good ones tonight.
Nice.
Chat.
Lobster hotbox.
We're gonna need your help. As soon as we finish reading off these articles, post your favorite three. We're only gonna have room for the favorite three or four that we mm-hmm. see everyone talking about. So you gotta help us out. There's too many good ones tonight. Lobster hotbox. Breaking into the monkey enclosure to feed them hot Cheetos.
As good as that is, I think there's so many better that we could leave that one off.
Fucking off on company time.
Okay, I could put that.
Not the sex doll bodybuilder. Invisible sculpture.
Invisible art? Mm. Yeah, I like that.
And then...
Just, I don't, there's so much chaos with this.
So much happened in this.
I don't
article.
Know how we can even quantify this into one sudden death. Let's go ahead, get your top three out, put them in the chat. We're watching and we'll create the poll.
Dude,
just give us a second.
I love ye old drip. I want another ye old rap. I really like extreme weed.
It's been a while for ye old. Okay.
And those are the marijuana munchie man that fits into extreme weed, I think.
Yeah. So my three, I would say ye old drip. Extreme weed is cool too.
Lobster THC ICC people saying, but that's lobster weed is kind of the extreme
I do love,
weed too.
I do love and we love Ninja here at yeah, the Mystery School Stream. So a true. Ninja suffering from success freestyle would honestly boost up the profile of TNB. Mm-hmm. I think that it would make him even cooler, man. So I really like that one as well.
Oh, invisible art too, or like art scanning.
Lobster. Honestly, I do want to throw in one of those like wild cards, yeah, like a ham bowl or like
lobster
a fucking
vape, lobster hot box.
Yeah, lobster hot box would be that, or how what was it?
Okay.
Baby Blue from
yeah,
Pretty Ricky. Like I don't care. Like those types are really funny too.
Lobster hot box, ye
okay,
old drip,
love
guaranteed.
That. Yep.
Those two are in for sure. Mm-hmm. Extreme weed, I think, should be in there.
So we got lobster hot box, ye old drip, extreme weed. Yeah, that's my top three as well. I can go with that. I could go with that,
I'm
man.
With it. Do we need a fourth
good
one, or should we keep it constrained to those? Those are the main
let's
ones.
Let's keep
I
it
see
constrained to those, man. All
right.
Let's do it just a three today.
All right. Okay. Shit coming up in a second. Make sure to vote on the poll, everyone. Our fate is in your hands.
Yes. We got lobster hot box.
There it is.
Ye old drip. And extreme weed as our top three sudden death topics of the night. Cast your votes now. The vote is up. Make sure you are counted.
Also, I want to tell you, I did a new update to the Mystery School Radio playlist. Got some new songs on here. I'm going to keep updating it. If you're looking for new shit to listen to, or you like the music that plays in the background of the stream, question mark playlist in the chat. And also, we didn't have a chance to look at this earlier. There were a bunch of setups posted in the Discord, man. I think we should take a look at these while the poll's rolling.
Let's do it.
We got... which username is this?
Wow, ISDD. You guys are really doing
nice
well here.
Doing some homework. Okay. Let's
nice
go.
Nice. Nice homework.
Dad Tay with some plants in the house.
Oh, I let's like go that hanging plant there, Dad Tay.
Chat,
that's a nice touch.
Make sure to vote in the poll. It's up right
keep
now.
Keep voting. Use your channel points and bits as well to sway the vote. Ye old drip needs... oh, God. Oh, fuck. I raffled all my points away trying to sway this vote.
is giving me a red alert saying you need 668 more channel points to vote. No. Am I fucking broke?
Cast your vote, chat. Remember, you can use channel points to sway it and bits as well if there's a topic that you need us to do.
This has got me. If anybody has some channel points and you want to vote for Ye Old Drip, I'll repay you on the back end. I got you tomorrow if you just drop 5,000 channel points on Ye Old Drip. Please,
guys. I wanted Ye Old Drip or Lobster Hotbox.
Come on, y'all. Shit. Please. Come on and do it, man.
Ye Old Drip.
Ye Old Drip. Let's get it up there, y'all. 5,000 channel points. It's nothing. You can afford it, man. Oh.
Arflux watching us at work here.
I don't have any bits or channel points. I'm a broke bastard. This sucks.
Ooh.
I got no agency here.
Damn, that's cozy.
It's coming down to the wire. It looks like
Ye Old Drip is in
Ye Old Drip has jumped up. Ye Old Drip has jumped
up. We're about to do it. Yes.
Damn.
Oh man. All right. Thank you guys. Thank everybody. Kango with 55,000 channel points.
Kango.
What a whale. Let's right go. There, man.
Oh, shit. I went to the wrong scene. I got too excited.
The Jeff Bezos. The Jeff Bezos of channel points right there.
Dude, Kango showing out. See, that's what having all the wealth is about, chat. Don't just accumulate channel points for the sake of accumulating wealth. You got to redistribute that. Spend it on the Mystery School economy. Whew. You know? Kango.
Because I blew all my points, man. I have no more channel points. I'm out.
Okay.
And I work here.
Oh, we got some real quick. I do want to just bring attention to some of these. Look at this. Andrew Fino eating good before the stream.
Oh, eating a little. Is that couscous? What'd you have there?
I see it, man. Ripples watching on two screens.
Dual screens.
Thank you for that. First Nation Sensation just cozy as fuck over here.
Oh, I'm loving that fireplace.
Ari
right
Flux
there.
Watching at work. We will not tell your boss.
Sick. Nice.
And
love it.
Felipe watching in IMAX here.
Is that, are you in a theater all alone?
Let's go.
That's cool.
All right,
cool
Chad, shit. It's time. You know the deal. Let me get this out of here. Let me get this out of here. Now it's time to pick the Ye Old Drip sample.
Yes, man. Good old Zelda drip. Yes. Good old Beethoven and Basquiat drip.
I always got Ye Old samples, man. That is one guarantee. I just found one the other day.
I'm looking forward to this, man. I know you got the Ye Old samples.
Kinda Ye Old.
This is giving me some Ye Old.
Ooh.
That's definitely some Ye Old.
Yeah.
Thou dripped was good in them.
Yeah, okay. That's a good one. That's one right there. Let's find one more.
Wow, that's giving me some Ye Old Drip as well right there.
That's kind of Ye Old.
That's giving me like Ye Old Gunna. Man, I had me Ye Old Drip. I rocked some vegans when I caught the plague and shit.
You want this to be number two?
Yeah.
Okay. That one's called Baby.
I think we're good. Yeah.
We're good. Okay.
Yeah, I think we're good to go with that.
Nick, you can throw up the poll. We got option one right here. This is option one. Both of these are good.
That's one right there.
Option two right here.
Get your votes in right now. Me personally, I'm going with two as well. Two is already in the lead.
Number
so
two.
I didn't sway the vote with that one.
Number one right here. And option two.
That's the one right there. The clock is already winding down. It's looking like it's going to be option number
it's
two.
It's by a fucking landslide.
In a lead by a landslide. So let's get it going, man.
All right. Let me take this out of the rotation here. Okay. All right. So what BPM was this? 160? Right.
Damn. Yeah. This giving me real Ye Old YSL vibes. Ye Old Slime Schlatt vibes.
Let's make sure this is in time and we'll get it going. Okay, we're good. It's Ye Old Drip freestyle tonight. You know what time it is, Chad. Drop those sudden death emotes. Remember, up here,
Chat sample comes in at the 20-minute mark. You all get to pick any sound I have to put in the beat. Just drop it in the chat. Nick is going to curate whatever it is and send it to me. At the 10-minute mark, it's time for the chat words. Three words that he needs to put into the song. You all get to pick whatever the hell they are. Kix is going to curate those. And we said we would try the AI verse again tonight. So, Kix, dude, you can go ahead and run a poll and put the options in to see who gets the open verse on this one tonight. Other than that, it's time. Ye old drip sudden death. The timer has begun. All right, let's rock. Damn, I got my headphones up loud as hell. I need like a snare first. You want like a little tiny percussion like they have in their shit?
Yes, I want this to be as like, imagine if Gunna was in King Arthur's court of knights. You know what I'm saying? It's got to be Gunna meets King Arthur on this one.
Okay, I got you. Let me just loop this. I'm actually going to make some variations of this first.
Yes. Yeah, I like that variation. Yeah, if it goes back and forth between those, that'll be nuts.
I kind of like this one. I want to start with this thin one.
Yeah, do your thing. That sounds good.
Okay.
Where are we? Okay, here we go.
Yeah.
28 minutes on the clock, y'all. Sudden death is underway. Let's get it.
Then it's like, doo-doo. Yep. Okay, I know what we're working with here.
Okay. For all of those that are new here, or if you've never seen a sudden death, we're going to make this song live from scratch in under 30 minutes. Allow us time to make the beat. Write some raps with you in the chat. If you got any bars or anything funny, insightful, creative, or cool to say about this song tonight, drop it in the chat and I'll try to put it into the song as best as I can. I usually do a pretty good job. Oh my God, Scary Pockets killed it. He said, this is if Lil Durk pulled the sword from the stone.
Yes. Let me do this.
Oh, man. Yeah, I love imagining, reimagining the entire YSL as
like a feudal legacy.
Medieval feudal, like war veterans right now. Yes, you on the right path.
Okay.
That sounds good. Sword unsheathed sound effect. Oh, yeah, you're right. Gosh.
Yep, yep, okay. I hear it.
I tilt my head, I put my sword up on my back. I'm gonna sword up on the stone in this H-slack.
Oh, yeah.
That's a bar. Oh, yeah, we gotta do that.
Yes.
Up on that. I tilt my hat. I put that sword upon my back.
Can I say slat?
I tell my head, crazy. I put that sword upon my back. I pull that sword upon the stone and then say slat.
Okay, I gotta get this roll perfect here.
All right, y'all. 26 minutes on the clock. Put that sword upon my back. Pull that sword upon the stone and then say slat.
Yep, there we go. Ooh, okay. Oh, I need that,
All right, y'all. Throw your best bars in the chat. If you got anything cool about tonight's ye old drip freestyle, throw it in the chat. I'm gonna type it into the phone and see if I can get some bars out of it. On that song about that stone and his age flat. Oh my God, what was lean like back in the ye old medieval ages, man?
There we go.
Don't step into the castle without that dripping in the basement. Oh wow, y'all are going crazy in the chat with these bars. Keep on dropping them in the chat. I'm reading some crazy shit right now. Chainmail, yes. Throw your best medieval references into the chat. I'm talking chainmail, dragon slaying, swords in stone, plagues, peasants, serfs. Anything you can think of, throw it into the chat. That'll help me write this rap. 24 minutes on the clock.
Yep, that was it right there. Okay. Grab this shit.
Why swamp milk, Dad Tay? Why is... I don't...
Swamp milk?
Is that something of medieval times? I'm unfamiliar with that one.
Maybe that's like lean?
Oh, lean equals potion. Okay, yeah, that's true.
Let me do this.
Oversteeped barley, Aggie Panda, that is true. Yo, Pringles Ruffles Nikes. Oh yeah, I gotta throw some meat up. I pour that soda out the stone in his age lad. Ye old harlots always talking about. Ye old harlots, yes. The old harlots keep on stalking me. The old harlots keep on stalking me. The old harlots. The old harlots keep on stalking me. The old harlots keep on stalking me. I got that cheese and broccoli, yes.
There we go. Okay, now I gotta just, like, bass boost the fuck out of the drums.
All right, we are 22 minutes on the clock. This is sudden death. Oh, yes, Bando got some bars. Anthony got some bars in the chat. Oh, Lockster.
I'm the freshest surf out here. Slash.
Oh, and thank you for those bits, Lame James.
James, love you, man.
If I throw on the chain mail, that's a nightmare.
Oh, I hear it. That's a nightmare.
She take it in her family crest. Slash.
She take it in her family crest?
Oh my God.
Slash.
I got the coin. Burlap on my body. I'm the freshest surf out. Oh yes, let's go.
Dude, we gotta keep that one.
Broccoli. Yeah, I like that. Let's go, Lame James. That burlap on my body.
There we go.
Oh, that's all about the stone and his age flat. The old harlots keep on stalking me. I got that cheese and broccoli, that burlap on my body. Yeah, that burlap on my body. Oh, we about to go in.
I feel like that's an accurate beat.
Well, where'd the rest of that go?
Okay.
Yeah, so this is done. Burlap on my body.
You like this part or you prefer the high-pitched one?
Oh, as far as the sample?
Because I'm thinking the verse will be like one of those. Like either this one.
This seems kind of versey.
Cool.
And the other one with the higher pitch, like flutes and stuff, I think that could be the hook. Oh, actually?
What do you think? I can alternate. I can use both.
Yeah, I think alternate them every so often.
Okay.
I think that'll be the best option.
Okay, I got you. So let me get this shit going here.
Questing. We out here questing? Till my head, I put this one up on my back. I put that sword up out the stone and it's a flat. The old harlots keep on stalking me. I got that cheese and broccoli that burn up on my body. I'm requesting for a daddy. Yeah. Oh wow. Okay. She said I'm crying. If I throw the chain mail, that's a nightmare. Okay, yeah. Lame James got plenty bars. What's the famous guy that gives you change? Johnny Dang. What's the other famous chain man? Icebox? I'm gonna just say Johnny Dang, dude.
Oh shit, I always forget about the sample. Oh, I forgot about that.
It's time for the chat sample, y'all. Okay. Owen has to incorporate tonight's chat sample into the beat some way, somehow. Let's see what it is.
What did you all give me tonight? Let's see here. I got it. I like to try to guess from the waveform. It doesn't look like a schlat. Oh, it's a sword.
Perfect. Okay. That is perfect. That goes really well with tonight's theme.
Can I, I don't know if this is allowed, but I do want to see if I can. Can I use that one instead? Will you allow it, Chet? I'll use both of them, but I do like that one as like a transition effect. I can use both. Hold up. SSG Zombie, welcome back, man.
SSG, thank you.
Okay, let me do this shit. I love that sword sound.
Shit, okay, where are we?
How much time? Okay. We're at the 20-minute mark.
Wait. Okay, all right.
There we go. Oh, what if it was like...
Gruul. Oh, I forgot about Gruul. Yes, I love Gruul.
Yeah, I'll use this as like a...
Oh, shit, I gotta move faster. We got 18 minutes on the clock.
I went like shlung tongue. Yeah, there we go.
Could I say Walkie Gruul? Would that be okay? I'm sipping on this Walkie Gruul.
Yes, that is great.
Walkie Gruul.
Yep, there we go. Okay.
Ooh, okay. Right. All right, I need a hook. Oh, God, I'm moving too slow. It's always the really good sudden deaths that I'm always moving slow on.
There we go.
Found an old castle basement. White chainmail, leather shoes basic. That's going on. Okay, yeah, I like that.
Gerald riding with me /
I got Gerald riding.
You got Gerald with you? Gerald from who?
I think he said Geralt. I'm assuming the Witcher.
Oh, God, more Gerald. Tight. Gerald with me. That is lit.
Let me actually take
nice.
We only need this to be 12 bars or else it'll be way too long. So I'm gonna do this. Then I can go back to this shit. Oh, I do need to go boom, boom, like that. Okay.
Minutes on the clock. This is sudden death.
I said, I heard it drip.
You know what? I'm gonna sauce it up like a madman. Let's do this. Yes. Let's stereo pan the sword sounds so they happen on different sides. Let's go like this. Headphone users rejoice. Okay. I need a crash and then I'm pretty much done. That's a good one. Let's do this one. Second verse, I have 3 minutes until I have to incorporate the chat words into the song. Three chat words will be chosen by you out there in the chat. I have to make them rhyme and go with the fucking song somehow. We'll see what happens. Okay, we back into the verses. Pull some haggis out the YSL satchel. Oh, Andrew Fino, yeah, that's it. Haggis.
Oh, James, dude.
Oh, are those more bars?
James, thank you, man.
Oh, let's go. Thank you, lame James. I'm about to pick some of those out.
The sword sounds shiesty. It is. The chat made me do it because that's part of the challenge of this shit. Listen, the beat is done. We're good to go. Have they decided on who the feature is going to be?
Is that the YSL? The YSL satchel. Let's fucking go. Andrew Fino snap.
Is that the YSL satchel?
Satchel.
Those sword sounds actually. Go ahead. It was MF Doom? Okay, I'm gonna prepare that already.
Where I keep my chewing.
I'm gonna put one of James's bars in. Turn the beat down a little bit while we're figuring this out. MF Doom, okay. Let me copy these James bars.
Oh, I like that battle. Okay.
Damn, that actually worked quick.
I pulled some haggis out the YSL satchel. I keep my chewers, got him smelling real.
I'm gonna actually see if I can start working in this MF Doom verse.
Oh, that'll be fire.
Let me see if he'll do this whole shit for James.
Did it give me it?
Okay, I think it's this.
Oh my god, let's go.
Download. Okay, I got it. I don't know what it's gonna sound like. Oh shit, it looks fucking crazy.
Please. Oh, who's rapping this?
MF Doom.
Oh, this is the MF Doom feature. Let's fucking go, y'all.
I don't know what's about to happen. This is going to sound crazy.
I don't know. It's just a disgrace. I'll take your place. I'll pray you get to play.
This is the end of the days. That's why I live and how I live and spend. I can get this in time. I can do it. Hold on.
I believe so. It sounds like it almost is. The way you swing the mates is a disgrace. I'll take your place. I'll pray.
The way you swing the mates is a disgrace. I'll take your place. I pray you get to play. Okay, that part's good.
Oh my god, this is getting intense. We got 10 minutes left. I'm about to have to do the chat words in 40 seconds, y'all. The way you swing the mates is a disgrace. I'll take your place. I pray you get to play.
This is the end of the days. That's why I live and how I'm living. It's gonna be scuffed, but we're gonna make it work.
The way you swing the mates is a disgrace. I'll take your place. I pray you get the plague. This is the end of the days. That's why I live and how I'm living.
Why is it doing that? This is gonna be scuffed, chat. What is happening?
Give
here?
Me the
Let's fucking go! Yes, let's fucking run! Let's fucking go, man!
So the AI definitely fucking
it shat that one out, guys. I don't know if that one will work.
It kind of spazzed out at the end there.
It's time for my chat words. I am under a lot of pressure here. Kix LaFleur, what will be tonight's three chat words? Oh my God. It looks like it's Ninja, Mead, and Dilly Dilly.
Dilly Dilly. Okay, fair enough.
All right. I'll incorporate those somehow, some way. Let me see. Mead.
The way you swing the mates is a disgrace. I'll take your place and pray you get the plague of this.
I cannot discern where the fuck the beat is on this.
The way you swing the mates is a disgrace. I'll take your place and pray you get the plague of this. Is the end of the days. That's why I'm living how I'm
Dilly
living.
Dilly Dilly.
Bed in gold, all my kinsmen. We made out the dungeon. The shit I smoke is pungent.
It actually kind of works.
Dungeon or should I smoke is pungent.
The part where he goes, it was actually kind of tight.
Okay,
yeah,
that
gotta,
was actually...
We got to record your part, and then I'm going to try to get the other parts on time here.
Yes, I think... Okay, give me 30 seconds.
Okay, I'll play the beat for you.
Okay. Okay, all right. Shout out to Lame James for that verse.
Dude,
for
James.
Our AI to rap.
Thank you, man.
Yuri, you're fucking right. Teriyaki with some bars in there. Sitting on my throne, smoking them. Okay, yeah. I like the throne in there. Okay. Okay. Right, I think we are just about good here. All right, we're good to go.
We're good to go.
Yep.
Okay. It's time. All right. So you will be coming in here.
All right. And this will be auto-tune one as well.
Got it. Right there.
Okay.
All right. Here we go. Coming in.
Yeah. I tilt my hat. I put that sword up on my back. I pull that sword up out the stone and then say schlatt. You old harlots keep on stalking me. I got that cheese and broccoli, that burl up on my body. Out here questing thotties. Johnny Dang did the chainmail. My cousin Ricky died from a hangnail. I'm sipping on this crew like Walkhart. Can't even get my car card because I'm getting sick off of black plague and shit. All they want is more.
No, that's
more
it, that's
fuck.
It.
Oh, okay, good. All right. Perfect.
Yes, that.
Oh, we went the fuck in. End.
All right, I need to find the auto-tune key.
Oh, yes.
That was
perfect.
That was fucking perfect.
That never happens. We fucking
minor.
Did it.
Okay, make sure this shit works. Waves tune. E.
Oh, yeah. Johnny Dang did the chainmail. Let's fucking go.
Let me see if this is the right one. 260.
Till my head, I put that sword up on my back. I pull that sword up out the stone and then say schlep. You old harlots keep on stalking me. I got that cheese and broccoli, that burl up on my body. Out here questing thotties. Johnny Dang did the chainmail. My cousin Ricky died from a hangnail.
Oh.
I'm sipping on this brew like Walkhart. Can't even get my car card because I'm getting sick off of black plague and shit.
Oh, actually, there was one more part. Shit, my bad. There's fucking four more bars.
Oh,
damn, I tweaked.
Oh, what, should we just cut it for the sake of the continuity of the song and just move the hook closer?
We can cut it unless you want to go off the top and we can just fill in these four here. What do you think? I'll go with you.
I would I would say let's just bring the hook right there, and then okay. on the second verse we got some
got
some wiggle room. That one ended too perfectly. I would say we just let that in.
Lead time. Okay. All right. So we got the coming into the hook. Fuck a timer tonight. All right. All right. Here we go. So you'll be coming in.
Sippin' on a school like walk hard. Can't even get my car card because I'm getting sick off of black plague and shit.
Right there.
Because I'm
ready to go.
Hold on, let me see. Okay, yeah, let's do it.
Here we go.
Because I'm getting sick off of black.
Oh shit, my bad. I did it too okay. early. I'm getting nervous.
Sippin' on this food like walk hard. Can't even get my car card because I'm getting sick off of black plague and shit. Yeah. Harder to drip. It's hard for me to bother when Gardner.
I'm back.
Oh, one more time.
Sippin' on this food like walk hard. Can't even get my car card because I'm getting sick off of black plague and shit. Yeah. Harder to drip. It's hard for me to barter when I'm guarding my ship. It was a part of me, my father was a part of the shit. And them ye old plagues, they came back and I need them Johnny dang old chains, yeah.
Oh, that flow was crazy. That's yes. It.
We got
yes.
him.
Yes, okay.
We got him. We got him, boys.
Grab this shit, put it over here.
Harder than a drip.
That was actually nuts.
Oh, we definitely doing it.
Drip. It's hard for me to bottom when I'm guarding my ship. It was a part of me, my father was a part of the shit. And the video plays, they came back, and I need them Johnny Dango chains, yeah.
Yeah, okay, then I do dude, this one yes. goes so stupid.
The ye old drip is fucking
you
full force right now.
You cannot go wrong with the ye old drip sudden deaths, man. They're just too Never. Fucking good. So let me make sure this loop's right.
Because I'm getting sick off of black plague and shit. Harder to drip. It's hard for me to bottom when I'm guarding my ship. It was a part of me. My father was a part of the shit. And them ye old plagues, they came back. And I need them Johnny Dango chains, yeah. Harder to drip. It's hard for me to bottom when I'm guarding my ship. It was a part of me. My father was a part of the shit. And them ye old plagues, they came back. And I need them Johnny Dango chains, yeah.
Yeah, second
Let's
verse.
Fucking go.
Oh God. Okay. Last four bars of the hook. Here we go, coming in.
All right, let's go. Let's get it. 3 minutes on the clock, y'all.
Was a part of the shit in the video plays. They came back and I need them Johnny Dango chains. Yeah. Put some.
Oh, one more time.
Gotcha.
You can start me a little closer.
Okay. Coming in.
Came back and I need them Johnny Dango chains. Yeah. Pull some haggis.
Oh, one more time.
Gotcha.
Same place. That's cool.
Came back and I need them Johnny Dango chains, yeah.
I pulled some haggis out the YSL satchel. Where I keep my chewing herbs, got it smelling natural. If you wanna see a battle with the Duke of myself, guarantee you're gonna put your doodle back on the shelf. It's a petticoat raid coming here in the day. If a ninja slice a blade, I'ma give him my plague. I drink some maid with my baby girl. We got drunk and spun in a twirl, dilly dally. Always try to touch me, dilly dilly. If you think it's silly, them britches coming up Philly. And it's nasty like a cheesesteak on the street. Touch my throne, the dragon you will meet.
Yes. Yes.
Oh, fuck.
Okay.
Did I use the chat words? I think I got them.
I think
Came
so.
Came back and I need them Johnny Dango chains. Yeah. I guess out the YSL satchel. Where I keep my chewing herbs, got it smelling natural. If you wanna see a battle with the Duke of myself, guarantee you're gonna put your doodle back on the shelf. It's a petticoat raid coming here in the day. If a ninja slice a blade, I'ma give him my play.
Okay, that's exactly what we needed.
I think we might be onto something right here.
So the third verse, fuck.
DaBaby Let's Go in the chat. Can we get a DaBaby Let's Go?
Let me. What do we? So, God, I have a little bit of this. First, but it won't let me synthesize a full 16 at a time, which I didn't account for.
Oh no, we got a minute 40 left on the clock. This is sudden death.
You want to do ad libs for the first part?
Yes. Oh, we can't just run it through?
Yeah, let's run it through and I'll start warping it while we're going.
All right, I think and for the this will be mostly doubles actually. So yeah, let's format it like that.
Okay.
I think doubles are more important than ad libs.
Okay, cool. Coming in right before the hook. Here you go.
Okay.
Sipping on this food like Wild Card. Can't even get my car card because I'm getting sick off of black plague and shit. Harder to drip, drip. It's hard for me to barter when I'm guarding my ship. A part of me, my father was a part of the shit. Them EO plagues, they came back and I need them Johnny Dango change, yeah. Harder to drip. It's hard for me to barter when I'm guarding my ship. A part of me, my father was a part of the shit. Them EO plagues, they came back and I need them Johnny Dango change.
Yes, that is, that's gonna sound yes. So good.
Oh yeah, we about to go in. 40 seconds on the clock.
Let me just get
40 seconds.
Fuck, we might have to Hail Mary the Doom part. Let me see.
Harder to drip. It's hard for me to barter when I'm guarding my ship. Yes, a part of me, my father was a part of the shit. And the EO plagues, they came back and I need them Johnny Dango chains. Yeah. Harder to drip. It's hard for me to barter when I'm guarding my ship. Yes, a part of me, my father was a part of the shit. And the EO plagues, they came back and I need them Johnny Dango chains. Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I wanted.
Yes, yes, yes. Six, drip. Five. 4, 3, 2, 1. And that is it. Hands up. The clock is off. This is another sudden death yes. completed.
Yes. Chat. You know the deal. This was sudden death.
Wow. A buzzer beater.
We had 30 minutes on the clock to make that entire song start to finish. And you chose the topic. Tonight's topic was, which article did it come from?
What did this come from?
It wasn't Ninja. Oh, it was, the fucking, it was this. It was the Ruffles shoes.
Oh, damn. It's crazy. These ugly ass weird shoes created yes. this fire, sudden death, man. Yes. It happens just like that sometimes.
The Ruffles armored ridge tops with fucking chainmail on them and stuff.
Chainmail. Real jousting shoes right there.
It reminded us of just ye olde drip, which has been a topic that we've touched on during sudden death multiple times in the past. And god damn, am I glad to have it back on the Mystery
School.
Oh,
wow. Loving it. Another just dripless medieval drip song right there. We love it.
Oh, my God.
Thank you to everybody who contributed to that one.
So I want to keep doing the AI, but I didn't realize there would be a limitation on it freaking out if you pasted an entire verse into it. I expected it would generate the whole verse. I would have time to warp it. But what ended up happening was I put in the whole verse and it started going because it was freaking out and spazzing out. So,
nice.
Yeah.
Nice. Yeah. Well, technology sometimes. Lame James, we apologize. Sorry, Lame James. The fucking AI. The technology is still very new and very precarious. We don't know what the fuck will happen here.
I'm going to warp it after the stream, and I'll post a version in the Discord with like at least the first 12 bars or so that worked out. Because we are fucking determined to make this work on the stream.
We love that fucking AI, man. That thing is tight.
And Lame James was put here in the Mystery School stream for many reasons, and one of them is to ghostwrite for fucking AI on the stream. That's yes. like one of the many things he contributes to the stream. So
holy shit. Yeah, Lame James, I think you found one of your many callings right there, man.
Hell yeah. All right.
One of many, dude. Well, fuck yeah.
Chat, Jesus. What a excellent stream.
That had my heart racing right there, y'all. It ran down to the wire. We pulled it out at the buzzer. That's what sudden deaths are made of right there.
Damn, man. That was... Oh. Thank you, chat, for enabling this. You did this. You allowed this sudden death to happen tonight. We appreciate that so much. Thank you for all the generosity tonight, everyone. That was just crazy. Let me run down...
Mind-blowing.
...the supporters. Dude, James, 1,500 bids. Thank you so much.
Thank you, man.
If you wouldn't mind, we'd love to put you on ghostwriting duty for all AI shit in the future. We were asking for you on Monday to see if you were in the chat when we were trying it out. Because we know you're made for it.
Hank Hill had to rap a verse, man. Yeah. But if you would do us the honor, man, anytime you're available, man, please write our AI verses.
So, chat, here's what we're going to do. It's the end of the stream. If you got to go to bed, we totally understand. But if you can stick around for another 10 minutes, please do. We're going to find someone to raid in the music section that has one viewer or less. We fucked up last time. We accidentally raided someone who was pre-recorded. They had live in their name and a sticker that said live on the stream. But we got bamboozled, and they weren't live.
Twas a lie, twas.
And the dude who we were considering raiding beforehand turned out to be super wholesome and very, very fucking cool. So I'm going to take a look to see if he's back online, because he seemed like a really cool guy and a talented musician. But if we can't find him, then we're going to look for somebody to raid. So please stick around. It makes these people's days, man. It's hard to stream, and even harder to find an audience. So you all can help us help someone out if you stick around. But real quick, I want to thank the donators and gifters. James, thank you for the 1,500 bits. Slopterbox with like 27 gifted subs today, I believe. If you're still out there, man, thank you so much for your generosity on the stream, bro. Laker fan with a couple gifted subs today. Mostway with bits. Teriyaki with a bunch of gifted subs. Terry, we love you, dude. In the thank running you, for man. The top gifter of the week. Thank you for your support. Frost the King with a gifted sub. Bryce562 with 5. Unique with 5. Young J with 10. Slopterbox with 5 more. Teriyaki with more gifted subs. The Ice Cream Lord with 20 gifted subs.
Let's go. The Lord right there.
Thank you so much for supporting the stream, man. It means a lot to us. Anthony with 5 gifted subs. Lame James with 10 gifted subs. He didn't win best bars in the chat for no fucking reason. This man is a monster. Thank you, dude. Seriously. We got House Graphics with 5 gifted subs. Young Sheffin with 1. 914 God. Slop Your Box with some more. Kilogrammer with 5 gifted subs.
Let's go.
Dipped in Twitch and Teriyaki with 2 more. Starting it off. Thank you. Excellent stream. Fucking excellent stream tonight, everyone.
Wow. Yeah, awesome. Just incredible, man. We rate these streams on a scale of 1 to 10 every single night, and we do a small sliding scale of how good it was. Tonight, 9.1.
Yes.
9.1 stream. This is excellent right here, guys. Literally, thank you. This is what it's made of.
Literally, the only thing that could make this stream better tonight is if we had time to do all of the articles and the AI worked. Those are literally the only things that I would have wanted out of tonight's stream that we didn't get.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, it's time to look for someone to raid. If you gotta bounce, we totally understand. If you're not already in the Discord, please get in there. It's where we hang out when we're offline. It's where we source all of the news from for the stream. If you see something that we need to talk about on the Mystery School stream, post it in the stream news section. ? Discord in the chat, or ? Socials in the chat. ? Socials has a link to everything. Our YouTube with full unedited reruns of entire streams and all of our like and follow and subscribe links, you know, the regular bullshit. So,
regular shit, y'all.
Hop in there if you're not already in there. And now let's find someone to raid. What is this?
Is that a bird's nest? I don't want a bird's nest stream. It is a fucking bird's. I was lying, bird's dude. Stream. I didn't think it was really a bird's nest, but yeah. It's a real bird's nest. This look, is kind of dope,
it says,
man.
Egg 4 of ?
I am fucking with that. Yeah. Is there a ? Exception that we can launch into here? So what's happening here? Is this a sleep bird? Oh, it looks like we got action.
And it's got a cool little bird radio.
The bird is awake. Oh, it's not even having babies. This bird is just chilling.
Nice.
I'm liking this stream. This honestly is pretty great.
That's a good one.
We'll keep that on deck in case we need a fallback option.
It doesn't appear to be interactive, though, which is very disappointing to me.
Ah, I wish there was some, like, ? Pour water on bird.
We record memories.
Uh-oh.
And remember the good times.
I like the good times.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hold on. Let's see what he's working with.
I have a...
It's a little feedback. You got it.
It's okay.
And my guitar. This is guitar.
You know this shit's live.
Offshore guitar.
You okay. Got it.
Come on, man. I want to hear what he's working with.
Give us the
he
shit,
said, let's
man.
Go. That's the key word.
Here we go, y'all. Give it a second. Ooh. Oh, man.
Soldier 16, all alone. What I gotta be.
What do you think, chat?
So we grow together.
I fuck with this guy.
I like it, man. I like that sound.
Yep, I love him. I think that he's our raid for tonight. He's definitely live. He's got someone in the chat. He's looking over, and there's feedback going on. So if this was pre-recorded, he would have edited this shit out.
So yeah. I feel like my trust issues can move out of the way and we can trust that this guy is live here.
Yeah. My second bet would have been that bird, but yeah. I think this guy's a bit more interactive than that bird. That bird looked like it was going to sleep and ready to tie it up for the night. So
yeah.
Let's go with a live human instead tonight. Next time we'll get the bird.
Let's do a live human tonight.
Yeah.
All right, everyone. He's going to get our raid. Be nice. Let's make his night or his day, wherever he is in the world. That's the point of doing these raids, is to just give some musicians on Twitch playing to not that many people an audience.
Man.
So help us out.
Give him some fucking sunshine in a dark night,
yes.
Man. I'm sure he'll enjoy you guys as much as he'll enjoy him. Just respect him, show him some love, and we'll play the Sudden Death again before we get out of here, and we'll see y'all on... Oh, it is Wednesday. We'll see y'all on Friday.
All right. We will see you again on Friday, same time, same place, right here on the Mystery School stream, 9 p.m. Central to midnight. We hope to see you there. Also, it's the return of Freestyle Friday. I added a freestyle beat suggestion section in the Discord. If there are cursed instrumentals that you want him to freestyle to on Friday, you know where to put them, in the Discord. All right. All right, everyone. That's it for us at the Mystery School headquarters. Thank you for an excellent raid. We're going to play that Sudden Death one more time and start the raid. I mean, an excellent stream. You know what I meant. Anyway, have a great rest of your night. Have a great day tomorrow. We'll see you in the Discord. Stay safe, stay healthy. We love you. Peace!
Peace, 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 peace.
Sword up on my back. I pull that sword up out the stone and then say schlep. The old harlots keep on stalking me. I got that cheese and broccoli, that burl up on my body. Out here questing thotties. Johnny Dane did the chain mail. My cousin Ricky died from a hangnail. I'm sipping on this food like Walkhart. Can't even get my car card because I'm getting sick off of black plague and shit. Harder to drip. It's hard for me to barter when I'm guarding my shit. It was a part of me, my father was a part of the shit. And them EO plagues, they came back and I need them Johnny Dang on chains, yeah. Harder to drip, it's hard for me to barter when I'm guarding my shit. It was a part of me, my father was a part of the shit. And them EO plagues, they came back and I need them Johnny Dang on chains, yeah. I put some haggis out the YSL satchel. Where I keep my chewing herbs, got it smelling natural. If you wanna see a battle with the Duke of myself, guarantee you're gonna put your doodle back on the shelf. It's a petticoat raid coming here in the day. If a ninja slice a blade, I'ma give him my plague. I drank some maid with my baby girl. We got drunk and spun in a twirl. Dilly dally, always try to touch me. Dilly dilly, if you think it's silly, then bridges coming up, filling. And it's nasty like a cheesesteak on the street. Touch my throne, the dragon you will meet. Harder to drip, it's hard for me to barter when I'm guarding my shit. It was a part of me, my father was a part of the shit. And them EO plagues, they came back and I need them Johnny Dang on chains, yeah. Harder to drip, it's hard for me to barter when I'm guarding my shit. It was a part of me, my father was a part of the shit. And them EO plagues, they came back and I need them Johnny Dang on chains, yeah. Harder to drip. It's hard for me to barter when I'm guarding my ship. It was a part of me, my father was a part of the shit. And them ye old plagues, they came back and I need them Johnny Dang old chains, yeah.
Okay, everyone, enjoy the raid.
Yes. This one was incredible. Great night tonight. Show him some love, show him some respect, and we'll see y'all Friday. Same time, same place.
Same time, same place. We'll see you then. Peace.
Peace, 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 y'all.